General Blake.
That's my name. To what do I owe the pleasure of your visit, Enforcer? We have had no incidents to justify the presence of military police.
I'm delivering these gentlemen.
Gentlemen? You use the term rather loose, don't you agree?
General Blake, your new recruits.
And when will they arrive?
They're right behind me, sir.
I see no soldiers here.
Soldiers of the future, sir. They are efficient and infallible.
And trigger happy. Or did you not know about the incident at Outpost Hatch where they slaughtered one another? I won't have them here. Not to mention this is strictly a Marine operation, not Army.
This is by order of Major General McQuiggan.
I will not suffer these blasphemies to nature in my operation. Frankenstein's wired up to get off from killing may be acceptable for other bases, but won't be tolerated here. These things don't understand what it is to be a soldier, or loyalty, and honor. I won't have them here.
You will take these soldiers, General.
I will not! I will do no such thing. I will hand in my resignation first. I strongly recommend that you and your friends get on out of here before I have you all shot. And bring me some real soldiers. Just another day in paradise, soldier. Evening, soldier. And when is the next test?
In just a few moments. I'm very confident we'll see results this time.
Said the same 5 months ago.
By the way, there was an officer in here looking for you.
An enforcer? We already had our chat. Seems some high power saw fit to dispatch army grunts here.
Grunts?
Little experiment our U.S. government conducted to make better soldiers by hooking up probes in their brains. Making the act of killing pleasurable. Made a bunch of goddamn morons is what they did. Were it not, I handled the enforcer.
Will you be after joining me on the floor?
Going up top. Just do your thing.
Status.
Everything is prepared, ready when you are.
Now on standby.
The suspense is killing me. Ain't gonna ever get that damn thing to work.
We're now on standby. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, trigger!
Gonna need some lab technicians.
So we get this thing to work. It's the last thing I do.
Staff sergeant. He's a mammoth. Bet you he was one of those experiment babies. Probably a clone. All that genetic meddling.
My name is Bent. B-E-N-T, Bent.
Oh, you can spell. I'm impressed.
But you would address me as Sir, or Major Bent. As your superior officer, you will do things my way and no other. This installation will be your home for the next 6 months. You will learn every intimate detail of this installation so well you could navigate it blindfolded. Per day, you are allocated 3 rest periods of no longer than 15 minutes. During these times, you have the privilege of eating and laboratory time, and during these times exclusively, you are allocated 5 hours of sleep and no more. You are strongly encouraged to take less for the good of this operation. You will remain at your post and make your rounds on a schedule I will designate. Any deviation from this schedule will be regarded as suspicious and handled swiftly and severely. Communication to the outside by any means is strictly prohibited. Any attempt made on your part, and I will see to it that you receive a proper vacation in Thornton Military Prison, where they have various special accommodations for traitors. I am judge, jury, and executioner, and you will respect my law or I will eat you alive. Sergeant Maxwell, do you find me entertaining?
No, sir.
Do you know what amuses me, Sergeant Maxwell?
No, sir.
I am highly humored by your history, Sergeant. I know about you. I know about all of you. Is it not true that you attempted to evade your duty to your country and the mandatory military service which keeps it strong? I find that despicable, Sergeant Maxwell.
You will find what you will find, sir.
I do not approve of your tone, Sergeant. Sergeant Maxwell, you will step forward. You Marines have been selected because of your exemplary military records and security classifications. But make no mistake, you are low. You grovel for the pleasure of being called dirt. Sergeant Maxwell is no exception.
Yes, sir. Dirt, sir.
I'm very pleased that you agree, because you are going to show me, Sergeant. You will lower yourself to the ground and demonstrate your lowness to us. On our fall, sir. That was a direct order from a superior officer.
Danger!
I have seen enough drilling for today, Major. Let these soldiers settle in.
squad dismissed.
We've been on the grounds for less than 48 hours, and I can already see that I will not approve of your methods.
You misunderstand my intentions, General.
Do I indeed?
I am sure you will agree when I say security is of the utmost importance, more so here than anywhere. We must have this facility under complete control to maintain the national security of the United States, so the technology being implemented here does not fall into wrong hands.
I assure you that I do not need to be schooled on how to do my job.
With all due respect, sir, imagine, if you will, a foreign power taking this technology and using it to instantly transport a set of nukes on our nation's capital. With no warning, no possibility of retaliation.
This slipgate may be little more than a pipe dream. The fact that we are here is a formality.
I hope you do not take offense, General, if I say you have no vision.
Your mere presence offends me, Bent. Would you be so kind as to explain what you were trying to accomplish down there?
I have always prided myself in my abilities to get the best performance out of...
I do not care about the code of conduct at Thornton Military Prison, where you'd been stationed due to disciplinary problems. And I don't give a good goddamn if you're the congressman's son. Perhaps your family ties are what allowed your transfer here, because your track record is disreputable. It is my firm suggestion that you do not allow the past to bleed into the present, or I will have your head mounted on my wall. Do you understand?
Understood, sir. Permission to speak.
Permission denied, Major. Dismissed.
Why don't they ever carry my brand of chips?
We're now on standby.
Deja vu.
How's things going down there?
As well as can be expected, sir. I just arrived this morning.
Welcome to the Slipgate Project, there. I hope your short stay is pleasant.
Short? No, sir. I'm here for the next 3 months.
Working in that pit? I wouldn't bet on it. I hope he's got a good insurance company. Major Ben, just the person I didn't want to see. How are you this morning?
I am mighty fine, General. I'm looking forward to history being made today.
Oh, yes, you should have been here for the last test. It was quite inspiring.
I never thought I'd see the inside of a place like this.
I've seen places more obscure than this.
Think I'd rather be back guarding that embassy where they had me for a year. Anything is better than battle, I suppose.
Battle just takes some adjustment. It can become just as monotonous.
What do you know about combat, Sergeant?
The battle at Elic Waters. I was there.
With respect, Sergeant, are you jerking my chain? Only one soldier was said to survive that.
Oh.
All systems running nominal. I trust all security precautions are in place. Yes.
Ah, military officers, huh? Your mothers must be proud of you then, huh?
General Blake, we have a situation.
Whereabouts?
The outer perimeter. We intercepted a scrambled radio message. I put my soldiers on full alert. We have spies snooping, or worse yet, planning to infiltrate. Permission to sweep the sector and detain.
Let's not give ourselves away so hastily. Reproduce this message for me.
As you heard, it's unintelligible.
The amount of time it could take to scramble it will be too late.
Vance, shut your trap. That was an order.
It just so happens there's a soldier on the grounds that can be of service.
Sergeant Maxwell, may I have a moment of your time?
Yes, sir.
Any of you guys want a breath mint? God knows you could use one.
The good Colonel Rowley called a scrambled radio message. I would like you to listen to it and offer an opinion.
My pleasure, sir.
The message, Colonel, on repeat play.
I've had enough, Colonel. Thank you.
Your assessment?
It's nothing, General.
I will need something more specific than that, Sergeant.
The men you have stationed near the main gates discussing the prospect of sneaking downtown to buy a few, how shall I say, tricks, Colonel Rowley. Sergeant Major Roman and Private First Class Polisota.
Thank you, Sergeant Maxwell. That will be all.
Many apologies, General Blake. I will handle this matter.
I'm sure you will, Colonel Rowley.
Begging your pardon, General, but I do not see how Sergeant Maxwell could have...
I do not recall giving my permission to speak, Major Bent.
Many apologies, sir.
Spoke again, Bent. One more time and you're on report.
Hundred and 145 languages, not including its fluency in binary code. 75 machine languages. You can descramble messages in any form on the fly. The man has a gift.
Where are you guys from, anyway? I've got some relatives in the Houston area. A very nice area to visit, I think. You guys don't say much, do you?
We're now on standby.
Here we go again. Major Bent, during the last test we had a problem with the machine giving off fumes that rose up here. Made a few soldiers drop. I feel for your own safety, you should back up some. Right on the edge of the control pit back there, yeah.
And what about you, General?
I'll be fine.
My name's Phil. P-H-I-L. Phil.
Be damned. How was your Christmas, Colonel Riley?
Uneventful. We had one civilian vehicle skim the edge of the sector, but they were clearly lost. Given bad directions, I suspect.
Didn't take leave for the holidays, then?
No, sir. The military is the only family I've ever known, but that's the way I prefer it. And you, sir?
I've got a wife and five glorious children, two of them full grown and pursuing military careers.
I'm sure your sons make you very proud.
Daughters, Colonel. Daughters. I must admit, after a few days, a part of me was itching to come back here. But then I returned to this.
Forgive me if I sound paranoid, General, but I can't help but to feel apprehensive about all these new faces.
No need to apologize, Colonel. It's your job to worry.
In the interest of security and containment, I trust these new arrivals have been properly screened.
Yes, Colonel. Though I'm beginning to wonder if our barracks are big enough to house them all. Damnedest thing about that slipgate. Still boggles my mind.
What, sir?
That armor disappearing like that. That thing went from Dallas here cross country to Richmond in the blink of an eye. Even after 3 months, it still hasn't sunk in.
They're using the slipgate regularly now.
Already?
Transporting goods and supplies.
A funny thing, when this was all just theoretical, nobody gave a care about the slipgate project. The government was on the brink of closing us down. Now everybody wants a piece of the pie.
If I may make a suggestion, sir, it would be advisable to put a cap on any more arrivals.
I wish it was my call. Over my head, I'm afraid. You can thank General McQuiggan for all of this.
Oh.
You can say it, Colonel. He's a shit. Tried to send Army grunts here at one time. The nerve of the man.
I remember that occasion. They came unannounced and came very close to becoming cannon fodder for my men. Luckily, the enforcer explained they were dispatched by order of General McQuiggan and Congressman Benton.
Benton? Major Bent's old man? Now why would he dispatch Grunts here and send his own son here to command them? Maybe he don't like his son neither.
I thought this was by your order, as I couldn't help but to notice you refused entry to one of the groups.
Well, the line has to be drawn somewhere. Last group was female soldiers, Colonel. With daughters at West Point, that may sound like a double standard, but with predominantly male Marines here, I like my soldiers thinking with the right head.
Understandable, sir.
Where, if it isn't Sergeant Maxwell?
Last time I checked, sir.
Don't take that tone with me. Are you not supposed to be on duty right now, Sergeant?
Not, sir. Or do I need to remind you of the schedule that you yourself devised?
I told you not to take that tone with me, Sergeant. The schedule has changed. You are to report back to your post.
With the utmost respect, sir. I have been on my feet for 15 hours with no rest time on little sleep. I'm going to my room now, sir.
Do not assume to tell me what you will or will not do. I am your superior officer and you will do what I say, no less.
I need some bloody sleep, Bent.
That is Major Bent.
It's Major Asshole as far as I'm concerned, and you can quote me on that when you write up your report for General Blake. Good day, Major.
Well, that's fine. You go and get some rest, Sergeant. I have a little present waiting for you when you wake up. You just earned yourself 10 extra hours of guard duty.
Sergeant Maxwell, you in here?
No.
Ah, sorry, my mistake. I wonder where it could be.
One, two, three.
Thought you could trick me, huh? Can't fool Phil, no.
What do you need, Corporal?
Don't sound so happy to see me. What are you, sleeping?
Yes, Phil, I talk in my sleep all the time.
Does your subconscious happen to know where I can rummage up some aspirin? I got a headache the size of South Dakota.
In the corner across the room.
Oh, what a pal, what a pal!
Childproof container.
Yeah, fail-proof, too.
Enjoy. I'm going to try to sleep now.
Yeah, okay. Have some shut-eye then, yeah. You got any water jugs in here? I can't swallow the pill without some water. I don't feel like crossing the base just to get some.
No.
Okay, get some rest. Decided to cross the base after all. Gonna pick up some pastries in the cafeteria. You want one?
No.
Maybe one of the kind with the jelly inside.
No.
I have a question for you. I take it this is a bad time.
I need to sleep now.
Yeah, you look like you could use a few wings. Yeah. I'll be going now then.
Good.
How are you today, Sergeant Maxwell?
Very well, sir.
I do declare I am mighty impressed by you, Sergeant. You've been making rounds for a day straight, if I'm not mistaken.
Should I thank you for that, Major?
You should thank me for making a good soldier out of you, Sergeant Maxwell. And I will, Sergeant. Even if it kills you.
As if I'd be so lucky.
We are transporting supplies today. The South End is in need of supplies for the armory and construction going on for the new wing of the installation.
Let me guess, my rest time is cancelled.
Hold your tongue, Sergeant. You are well aware of what happened last time. You've nearly worked off your demerits. You'd be wise to watch your tone.
Yes, sir.
Your post has been changed, as of now, to the South Sector to supervise and aid in the receipt of these supplies.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. How long before the transport is available?
You're mighty welcome, Sergeant. And there's no transport, Sergeant Maxwell. You will march to your post on foot. If I find out you got there by any other means, you will have more guard duty to look forward to. Dismissed!
Make sure you stay clear of the slipgate while descending. You were all standing much too close for comfort last time.
I've been curious as to what kind of danger that thing represents to soldiers.
To be blatantly honest with you, General, I haven't the clue.
Well, that's very reassuring.
We're scheduled to run some tests next week on transporting biological things. I'm afraid the results are unpredictable. There are things about the slipgate that even I myself do not understand.
Well, a few questions come to mind. During the first successful test, you sent a crate to Richmond. But now these supplies are going cross base, maybe a quarter mile.
Aye.
But why Richmond then and somewhere else now? How does it know where to go?
Every slipgate gives off a signal, a signature. To link them, you must tune in the other.
Tune it in?
Aye, much like a radio station. Only this is our location.
So you need a slipgate on both ends?
Not necessarily. You can still set a slipgate to a specific location, if you've recorded that location's signature.
Thank you, I've heard enough. My hair's spinning already.
Good day, Sergeant. My apologies, but we were expecting you 20 minutes ago.
Think nothing of it, Sergeant. Just took some time to get here, is all.
Why didn't you call for a transport?
Don't ask. Has the last of it arrived?
No, sir, we're waiting on the final batch, but as you can see... we're having some technical problems.
High time I retired for the day. You're in command, Major Bent.
My pleasure, General. What's that smell, and why is it so chilly in here?
Only the cooling agents, Major. We're using the ventilation system to bring the main chamber to 40 degrees. So a way of cooling her off till we come up with a better method.
Very well, then. Let's get on with it. One more batch.
Get on with it? No, sir. We stand the risk of overheating the coils if we do now. Better to wait.
I am the commandant at this time, and I say we are behind schedule, which is unsatisfactory. We will finish transport now, sir.
Playing King of the Hill already, Major? With the general gone for only a few minutes?
Do not question my authority. Just do it!
As you wish, sir. All right, everyone up front. How did this happen?
I think something's jamming it.
Just came to a dead halt. I'll go see if I can't find one of the engineers.
Madoc, before you do that, go to the main controls and shut the machine down before it completely burns itself out.
Yes, Sergeant.
All right, gentlemen, how do you propose we get up there to fix it?
Been thinking the same thing myself.
Don't you suppose I should have informed the soldiers on the south end before I started sending, sir?
I will radio them when the transfer is complete, Dr. Keith. Just do your duty.
I'll shut down. I'll radio Central and let them know we're having a...
You'd better do it quickly.
Central, this is Sergeant Murdoch on Southside Dock 8. This is urgent. Over.
This is Major Bent. Go ahead.
Stop transfer now, sir. We're experiencing technical problems. Repeat, do not send the final batch.
We have already sent 4 out of 5 crates, Sergeant.
We've received nothing.
What's going on?
And the last one is being sent right now.
Repeat, we have received nothing. I don't know where you're sending, but it's not here.
Ah! Oh, Lord!
What is that? It's Damon's phone, that's what it is.
Hold your fire, but don't take your eyes off it, Murdoch. Let Central know we have a problem.
I knew this was going to happen all along.
Be quiet, Corporal Polisoto.
Did you or did you not receive the crate, Sergeant Murdoch?
We did not, sir. We got something else instead.
We were messing with nature against God's will. Oh, forgive me, Lord.
Shut up, Corporal Polisoto.
Forgive me, Jesus, for being party to this.
Shut the fuck up!
Foreign life form, sir. Requesting instructions and reinforcements now.
What do you mean?
God damn you, Major Bent. It's an alien life form. Right here, in the flesh, right fucking here. Send back up now, you incompetent piece of shit!
What's that noise he's making?
A serpent's tongue. He's trying to communicate.
He's moving!
Hold your fire!
What's he doing?
He's calling his demon so he can cast his devil magic on us.
Where's my family? I mean you no harm.
Well, I ain't gonna let him. I ain't gonna let him!
Polisoto, no!
Shut up!
It's gone, sir.
One way or the other, we're going to get to the bottom of this.
They didn't receive the crates, and I wonder where they went. What was in the major bins?
Last two had ammunition, nails and grenades. The others were tools for construction. Mostly chainsaws.
Chainsaws?
Is there a reason for this call other than to tell me what I already know?
I was not aware I needed an excuse to contact my own father.
You always have an angle. My time is precious. What do you want, son?
Transfer, sir. 6 months have come to pass and I have done my duty.
After that affair with the slipgate, nobody leaves.
On the contrary, father, unless you are intimidated by General McQuiggan.
Don't be ridiculous. He's lint in my pocket. All the generals are short of that Zachary Blake.
Then you will have no objection to seeing to my transfer to somewhere closer to Georgia. Not to mention I feel unwelcome here.
Come now, it's my understanding that General Blake is quite hospitable.
Father, please.
Ben, my son, I've always wanted nothing but to keep you safe. To protect my own. That's why I got you out of that nasty prison post. But you've yet to prove yourself to me, son. And your country still needs you.
Need I remind you that we have been running at 200% efficiency here since my arrival? I have worked these soldiers...
into the ground from what I hear, but you have a golden opportunity to be of service to your country, son. You understand that America is in a recession, the likes of which hasn't been seen in years. A war, an offensive, is best for the economy.
I do not follow you, father. War with whom?
This slipgate technology could save our good country millions. New industry, new means of transportation, new jobs, it's all good. But this alien that came through the gate, son, if there's one, there's many. They represent a threat to national security. The situation must be handled properly.
Sergeant Maxwell was on site during that occurrence and does not share your view. I may not like him much, but he has good instincts.
Opinion of Sergeant Lawrence Maxwell is laughable.
General Blake supports his assertions, father.
And you will counter those assertions with a few skeletons in Maxwell's closet.
Sir!
Some records have been sealed for 5 years now. Funny thing happens in a couple minutes, Ben. They are dumped into public record. Computer errors happen all the time. Seek and ye shall find.
You almost ready, Sergeant? We've got 40 minutes.
Morning, madam. Yes, I am aware.
I don't know why we have to go through this shit again. I don't see why General McQuiggan just doesn't read the goddamn transcripts. Do you think our stories are gonna change?
Maybe that's what he's hoping for.
Sergeant?
Nothing.
Is your story gonna change?
Why should it? I'll tell the truth as I did before.
So what's so interesting out there?
The view, Murdoch.
Tell you the truth, it looks like a bunch of sand, rock, and dirt to me.
I bet it looked the same 1,000 years ago. Natural, untainted. I'd bet the sunlight hitting it wasn't so lethal either. As there was actually an ozone layer. No radiation from botched nuclear power plants.
Don't get deep on me, Sergeant. Not so early in the morning.
The very air out there is offensive to breathe. From us belching filth into the sky for 100 years. I don't think the Earth will tolerate us for much longer.
I didn't know you were one of those environmentalists.
Just a rational being, Murdoch. A rational being. That creature who came through the slipgate. Where do you suppose he was from? A place like ours? Or a place like that? 1,000 years ago.
Hey, wait up!
Pay a special attention to the perimeter. No one in, no one out. At all costs. Use force if necessary.
Then we should use our own discretion, Colonel.
I would expect nothing less, Sergeant Major.
Of course. I'm only looking forward to it, sir.
Looking forward to what, may I ask?
Terminating threats to security, sir.
Well, aren't you the eager one? What's gotten into you, Sergeant Major?
It's the implant, sir. It increases his enthusiasm.
Enthusiasm isn't the word I'd use. And what of implants? I authorized no such thing.
General McQuiggan ordered it. Took only a half hour. We all have them, sir. I think you should, too. Yes, it's wonderful.
I've heard enough. General McQuiggan and I will have words. Until then, protect the area.
He should have one, too.
I demand an answer.
Well, forget yourself, Colonel Raleigh. You're addressing a Major General. Colonel Raleigh is upset, which is perfectly understandable.
It was underhanded, General McQuiggan.
Keep it up, Colonel. I'll have a relinquisher of duty and rank. Can't stand in the way of progress. We're making efficient soldiers here. Wars of the past have been lost because of conscience, I say. Conscience. Soldier with a conscience is no good. Finds killing unpleasant. Need strong, cold soldiers. Need them to be the coldest of them all forever to reclaim our position as the main superpower of the world. It's all volunteer, Colonel. Not mandatory. Certainly not for a ranking officer such as yourself. But I'd recommend you get one.
No, thank you, General.
The Colonel will come around.
Do you sleep well at night, General McQuiggan?
Tell me what's that supposed to mean? Assaulted by a colonel and now a brigadier general. Highly irregular, you know.
My apologies, General. I'm just curious as to what you say to these soldiers to get them to agree.
Well, tell them it'll make them sharper. Tell them it'll make them better. The truth.
But what do you say to their families?
You can lock up the archive now, sir.
Did you find what you were looking for, Major Beck?
Oh, yes, I am mighty satisfied.
We're awaiting instructions and backup from Major Bent. Corporal Polisoto lost his composure and opened fire on the creature.
Are we to understand this was without provocation?
There was plenty of provocation. That thing was looking at us all bloodthirsty and evil-like.
Begging your pardon, while the creature wasn't all that attractive, I do not believe he had any malicious intent. He looked just as shocked and confused as we were.
What do you mean, confused? Elaborate on this, Sergeant Maxwell.
We were as alien to him as he was to us.
Mind explaining how you know this?
He said so, sir.
Sergeant Maxwell has a gift for descrambling messages and translating exotic languages. It took the creature speaking twice for me to pick up on it. Very roughly, he wanted to know if he was being held prisoner. He wished to know why he was here, and where his family was.
Very roughly? What do you mean? Thought you could understand him clearly.
It doesn't work like that, General, not verbatim. I got the gist of it.
And if the gist was out of context?
Then so be it, but one thing he uttered was very clear to me. The last thing he said before Polisoto fired.
Which was?
I mean you, no harm.
No harm, nothing, that thing but 8 feet tall, 500, 600 pounds. I think I even saw blood on his hands. It wasn't no peaceful creature. It was a devil incarnate.
I believe it's on record that I stand by his assessment. His skills are well documented also.
It is not a matter of skill, it is a matter of credibility.
Any reason why you see fit to interrupt this way, Major Bent?
To cut short this fallacy.
More than you, Major Bent. Spit an image of your father, you are. You come to say something, say it. I'd love to hear it.
Many thanks, General McQuiggan. May I address Sergeant Maxwell directly?
Whatever pleases you, Major.
Sergeant Maxwell, is it not true that you were once a lieutenant?
It is so, sir.
My, we've suffered a drop in rank.
You're a master of observation, Major.
Would you care to share with us how that came about? I asked you a question, Sergeant.
Stemming from an affair whose details I cannot disclose.
And why is that, Sergeant? It is a matter of public record. The good generals will receive a printout of the documentation when this hearing is through. Remedy our suspense in the meanwhile.
Public record impossible. Those records were sealed.
I am not a liar, Sergeant Maxwell, such as yourself. Have no worry. You will also receive a printout.
Joy.
35 Marines stormed the enemy front lines in Paris, dying in a blaze of glory. Or so the history books say. But that's not entirely accurate, is it?
I hope you're going to arrive to a point sometime soon, Major Bent. It's a hot truth, sir. They did indeed charge the front line under order of Major Gregory Wyatt.
And what of you, sir?
I withdrew and attempted to persuade others in doing the same.
In other words, you disobeyed a direct order from a superior officer and then attempted mutiny.
We were grossly outnumbered and too far from familiar ground in the dense wilderness. We were short on supplies and they were armed to the teeth as they were defending their encampment. Retreat was the only move that wouldn't result in inevitable slaughter.
That was not your decision to make. Major Wyatt apparently did not see things the same way. You deserted your own men and undermined Major Wyatt's military faculty.
Major Wyatt's faculties were drowned in bourbon and those men died because they wanted to win more than they wanted to live.
You say this because they would not betray their country, Sergeant.
No, because they were willing to betray themselves.
Tell us what happened next, Sergeant.
A third of the company died from heavy fire on the initial charge. The remaining soldiers held their ground for a short time before finally disengaging. Another half went down during the retreat and the remaining men were decimated by a surprise attack to the flank.
Do you not suppose they may have not considered retreat had you not planted the seed in their minds?
Whether they retreated or followed through at that point, the result would have been the same. They were ghosts the moment they crossed the line.
Ghosts, you're ghosts, because you have to live with the fact that you watched your fellow soldiers get butchered while you stood idly by as a coward.
Half the battle is knowing when you have lost. That's enough.
Well, when first asked to give a statement, did you lie and say they never attempted retreat?
I was protecting the memories of those soldiers so their families could be proud of them.
As opposed to shame, Sergeant Maxwell, for being yellow-bellied cowards like yourself.
Do not assume to judge me or those men.
Perhaps they could have derived strength from your character and faith in them as soldiers. You instead planted a seed of doubt in their minds. If they would have never retreated, they may have had a chance.
You were not there, Bent.
And neither were you. It was you who betrayed their memories. It was you who made them ghosts. You might as well have shot all 35 of those men yourself. You are not only a liar, a coward, and a traitor, but a murderer too!
Bastard! I'm going to rip off your appendages and beat you to death with them right before I rip your black heart out of your chest with my bare hands and ram it down your goddamn throat!
Whoa, calm down, Max!
Compose yourself, Sergeant Maxwell.
Or I'll suffer this disrespect. Get him out of here.
Keep moving.
I'm going. Well, now that we've gone completely off topic.
I don't believe we have. Sergeant Maxwell isn't a credible witness. About the slipgate, any ideas how this happened?
Dr. Keefe can answer this question.
Major Bent ordered transfer before the machine was ready, sir. Coils overheated, and in some way I have yet to understand, caused a miscalculation. Should have been picked up immediately. Due to the negligence on the part of some of my engineers, it was not.
Fire these engineers, got new ones. I want the slipgates back up and running.
With our respect, you can't be serious, General McKay.
Progress, General Blake. Progress. Dr. Keith, you're not to push the machines under any circumstance from here on out. Including orders from Major Bent or General Blake, you're in charge.
Thank you, sir.
I'll clear doubling your staff to monitor the slipgate so a miscalculation didn't happen again. Even it has to be checked, double-checked 100 times for each send. We're behind schedule. My plane leaves for Washington shortly. Good day, gentlemen.
Soldier Boy went wild out here and knocked him unconscious.
Yeah, it was kind of funny, come to think of it.
There's nothing we can do.
I tend to disagree. These enforcers and MPs, no offense to you, are not very bright because of those implants that are going around like candy. They'll be quick to assess the situation as warranting combat with whatever's on the other side of this slipgate mess.
I would recommend legitimate investigators, but I know of none with a high enough security clearance.
Therein lies the problem. Being that we as high-ranking officers are not bound to these grounds, how would you feel about getting away? Maybe so you can clear your head about this unfortunate business with your men getting implants.
I hardly think this is a good time for it.
There would be a purpose. There's a man I've worked with in the past who could be of great service here, I feel.
His security classification?
Higher than even me. It solved mysteries previously thought to be unsolvable. Worked on the most top-secret operations our country has ever conducted. The government often used him as a spy. Remote viewing.
The government has been using psychics for years.
Remote viewing?
Clairvoyance. 95 times out of 100 remote viewers are dead on the money. There's definitely something to it. This man has graphically described foreign military installations a few thousand miles away. Like Sergeant Maxwell, he has a gift. Only Maxwell has the ears. This man has the eyes and the mind.
Who is he?
His name is Jack Torres. If you agree to collect him, it would be advisable to treat him like a hostile prisoner.
I must be missing something here.
I said he worked with the government. I didn't say he liked it. He's also a former Navy SEAL, so he can be quite the handful.
Any suggestions on where to find him?
I got a pretty good idea.
This is Lieutenant Reed at the border. Be on the lookout for a large body of American soldiers. 900 hours, several wanted from their posts. There's no confirmed headcount. The only existing commonality between these soldiers are Series KX-58 brain implants. Consider them dangerous if you run across them.
We'll keep an eye out for them. Many thanks, Lieutenant.
It's safe to stay here. You should leave, Tony.
No, this is my business. You go.
You be careful, then. Don't take any unnecessary chances. I will find the phone and contact the American authorities. Tony, if they come back.
You let me worry about that. You go. You hurry back.
Yeah, yeah, I'm on the Mexican Wow Radio.
Be quiet, you buffoon! I think we've been traveling in circles. Follow the map. There's not exactly road signs out here, and this fog isn't helping. Check the satellite tracking system.
No, can't do that. That'd be like asking for directions. Men don't ask for directions.
How are the engines? On the brink of overheating. We've been running for too long. We're going to have to park it for a while. Do so.
A bit cool out here. I thought Mexico was supposed to be hot.
Not as much. The drastic climate changes. Something to do with those meteors that hit us some years ago, I'm sure.
Yeah, a lot of people died in that, yeah. So now what do?
We wait.
So, how far from the country line are we?
50 miles or so.
Ah, yeah. Not that I know much about Mexico. Except they make tacos. They do make tacos, right?
Colonel Raleigh, sensors indicate a structure not far down this road. Distance? 100 meters or so. Both of you remain here and guard the crash.
Why? You're gonna go solo?
Mr. Torres has to be handled delicately. And I suspect you'd be more of a hindrance than a help, Corporal Phil.
Why? What's that supposed to mean? The General sent me along to assist. I'm a trained professional.
Did you ever consider the General wanted you out of his hair because you're a pain in the ass?
Hey, that was uncalled for. You hurt my feelings. I'm a very sensitive man.
Don't move or I blew your head off.
Are you Jack Torres?
No, you're goddamn Undertaker.
I came looking for no trouble. Only Jack Torres.
Is that why you say those goons, they are destroying my property?
Goons?
Soldiers, idiots, grunting.
Army grunts. Consider yourself lucky to be alive.
Was that a threat?
No, sir. These soldiers you saw have experimental implants that went AWOL. U.S. Army. I am Colonel Rowley of the United States Marines.
A Marine? How am I supposed to tell? You all look the same to me. Look what they did to my business.
They did all this.
All of what? They broke my door, the bastards!
It appears we have company. We're going to enjoy watching you die!
Hey! I got one word for you guys. Boom. You Jack Torres.
That all depends on who's asking.
I'm Corporal Phil and I'm asking. What kind of accent is that?
I'm from lots of places. Why are you asking? What do you want from me?
Now is not the time to play 20 questions, Jackie boy. You got two choices. You either come with us or I say the B word again.
The B word?
I'd advise the former, Mr. Torres.
Yeah, the B word. I'd say it again for you, but you won't be around to reflect on how profound it is.
Tony!
Tony is no longer with us. They terminated him.
Oh, shit.
Come with us now.
Think I'm just going to leave him in there?
There's nothing more you can do for him.
I would give him a proper burial.
I don't know, I feel a word coming on. A word. I wonder what it could be.
He was my friend! He will have a proper burial, have a little respect.
Very well then. But after, you come with us.
Yeah, really? And then where are we going, huh?
To see General Blake.
Wait. Zack Blake? General Zack Blake? I swear to God I'm going to kick his ass. I'm going to kick his ass.
Yeah. Dismiss their concerns. What is that you have there? The gods gave us these, but not enough for all.
Oh, the gods indeed. I'm sure the great builders took the time out of their divine schedules to give the lot of you chainsaws to play with.
Huh? Weapons, then. How thoughtful of the gods. To guide a shadow, you could reproduce this device for the worker population.
We can recreate anything, but that is neither here nor there.
Chieftain Grunter, return to the mines. I will join you shortly. Permit me to talk some sense into the good hire.
What is it you think you are doing, General?
Tell me, High Archigider. How did the humans learn your magics? Teleportation.
Their magic is different. They build machines to do magic, and they can barely control their own inventions. Such is their way.
It's only a matter of time before they start visiting here again. 4,000 years ago, during the Horror's reign, they caused enough problems. Now they are advanced.
Advanced in all the wrong ways. Shub-Niggurath has ordered a full inquiry to the whole affair. Are you willing to take your soldiers on an expedition, gathering some specimens for examination?
Yes, and I will bring Groto and his war party, too.
What? Preposterous!
They are an oppressed people, the Guider, but they have honor. They have their values, no matter how primitive. It's the one thing we've left them with.
Don't tell me you're an ogre sympathizer.
Cause and effect. You don't give them a taste of vengeance, revenge, no matter how small the measure. There could be another rebellion.
Over the death of one ogre? Ludicrous!
Need I remind you that the last rebellion began when a knight insulted a chieftain? This time, humans killed a chieftain's son!
Cause and effect, General Garo. Shub-Niggurath wants discretion. A handful of humans disappearing is one thing. Many dead ones is something else entirely. There will be repercussions.
Either way, there'll be repercussions. Discretion will not avoid conflict, only postpone it. You know humans.
Yes, a vestige of a mystery, and they will stop at nothing to solve it. They will meddle or snoop and become a nuisance to us. It's in their nature.
And there you have it. Besides, you know, most of the humans end up here eventually on their own, regardless.
I need a vacation.
Fucking grunts. Why do I have to work with them?
You having fun staring at the wall down there?
Yeah, loads, man. Loads.
I don't know why we bother security, Driller. Nobody has any reason to come here.
In 10 minutes, we'll be running a security drill. Meant to keep you sharp. Full participation is mandatory.
Grunts. I hate grunts. I hate them. I hate them.
Going to die!
I'm like so bored.
What the hell? Never had a drill like this before!
Come on, bitch!
What are these things? Holy shit!
Underestimated them and their new technology. Listen up. We take what few are left living, we take our own dead, and we leave the dead humans here as a message to the rest of them. The next order of business is to see what makes these green ones so spirited.
course you can replicate the settings of the day of the incident.
Exactly. Taken directly from the machine log. But it's more than settings that truly recreate it. It's creating the imbalance the overheating coils did.
Is this even possible?
Yes, sir. Reprogramming it to simulate it as we speak.
What kind of imbalance did it create?
What I know is that it made an irregularly shaped gate. The slipgate mainly works with electromagnetic fields emanating from four cardinal directions, buckling in the center, and ideally creating a sphere, a hole. That day, the shape of the anomaly was more oval and turned in on itself.
Is there an English translation to this?
Imagine making two dots on a piece of paper, folding that paper so the dots are aligned, and ramming the tip of a pencil through the sheet, straight through. That day it was off.
So it's like ramming a pencil through in the wrong spot.
No. More like running it through at the wrong angle.
That still doesn't explain why something else would come through instead.
This is all just theory, General Blake. The chances of it happening are incredible, but it could very well be that wherever that crate ended up, this creature was in the same spot and pulled through the hole.
If the crate was sent from here, then why didn't the creature come through this one?
I don't understand that yet. The only place a creature could have ended up was a destination point, which as we know is where he already was. Yet he arrived at the intended destination point, which is very bizarre.
We are all set up here and prepared for surprises this time.
What's being sent this time? Looks like a backpack.
It is, with a tracing device in it. If it ends up anywhere on this planet or in the solar system, we'll be able to pinpoint.
Being that the creature couldn't have come from our solar system, you might as well kiss it goodbye.
We can't just sit on our hands. We need to find out what we're up against.
Sergeant Maxwell believes they did not have ill intent. I am inclined to believe him, regardless of this mud kicked up about Elic Waters. So this is the place.
Indeed, it's my understanding that they're running a test, so we will wait until they are finished.
Tell me something, Colonel Riley. What is that thing?
That would be a slip gate.
Aye, did I miss anything juicy?
Not especially.
Everything is ready.
Skip the countdown. Let's do it.
As you wish, sir. We're sending now.
Everybody alert! The time has come!
We were unsuccessful, sir. It arrived at its destination. I'm off to thinking I received the package over there.
We have received nothing, sir.
That's impossible.
What is it?
They claim they have not received it, yet the trace pinpoints it directly on the slipgate pad right before their eyes. I don't understand. I'll switch on its pulse. Are you sure now? The object is traced and records its location right there.
I am not blind, Director Keith. It is not here.
Do you hear anything? A beeping?
No, sir.
What could this mean, Director Keith?
Sideways.
What?
Sideways. It went sideways.
Start making sense, Director.
The same location and space in a parallel dimension or reality. I'm going to try something.
What's that?
To bring it back. The other slipgate is sent to send and receive. I can control it from here.
What are you gonna do? What are you gonna send?
I'm going to send nothing but air. Create the hole and see if the backpack slips back through.
We should think about this.
Right.
We have received the package, sir. Intact.
I'll be damned.
We got it back.
Sensational.
General McQuiggan, the lab results are back.
Lab results on what?
Some of the creature's blood. What did you find out?
The DNA is very similar to our own. The environment from which he came is very close.
How close?
It's close enough.
It's time to take this all a step forward. General Blake, need about 5 of your best men to scout the alien landscape.
You're completely out of your mind. To go through that slipgate?
Soldiers?
That was an order, General Blake. We already know it can transport living things. We know we can recover things. We know our signals can be picked up on the other side.
It needs to be thoroughly tested, General. You can't...
Shut your mouth, Director Chief.
This is dangerous. I cannot order them to do this, General McQuiggan.
Then I'll call for volunteers first. You all have a chance to make history and be of service to this country. You can be the first to see what no other human has ever seen. There's risk. Something could go wrong with the device, or something could go wrong when I'm trying to bring you back. The choice is yours. But remember why you're wearing those uniforms.
Come in. Fellow go. Yeah.
I volunteer as well.
I'll go too.
If we encounter these creatures, I can attempt communication with
you. You can't be trusted, Sergeant Maxwell.
Hey, if Max don't go, I don't go.
Is that an ultimatum?
Yeah, you bet your ass it is.
We need a few more. Put tracers on a lot of you and we'll maintain constant radio communication. The radio's built into your helmets. Let's see what's on the other side. Y'all have 30 minutes. Call whoever you gotta call, tie up any loose ends, and prepare to never come back. But prepare to return as heroes to your country.
Sleepgate standing by, ready?
Soldiers, you all make me very proud. May God be with you.
Those of you going, walk straight forward into the slipgate pad, slowly. Closing your eyes is suggested. The transport should be instantaneous. It is very important you continue to move forward once you've arrived there.
On my word, begin. Now.
Aye, that he did. Continue.
Keep moving.
Like shit out here.
This is General Blake. Everyone make it all right.
We're here, yes. Wherever here is.
General McQuiggan.
Yes, sir.
Outpost Morale was just attacked. No survivors.
Oh my God.
By whom? Sensors revealed magnetic anomalies typical in slipgate transmissions. Foreign life forms as well, sir.
Son of a bitch, it couldn't be.
It has to be. This goes far beyond an incident now.
Sergeant Maxwell was wrong about them being peaceful creatures.
Get these soldiers back now!
I may have just sent 5 men to die.
They built this. Quite advanced.
Yeah, well, I hope they built a little boys' room, too, because I'm having a party emergency.
I can't believe you're worried about your bladder at a time like this.
What do you expect? I feel all queasy from going through that slipgate, and now this green stuff is irritating my sinuses.
Team 2, the mist is thickening over here.
Just suck it up, Team 1, and guard that spot for our safe return. We're investigating a structure here.
So, you think anybody's home?
Tell you the truth, I'm hoping not.
Have no worries, just let me do all the talking.
That was the plan. The hell could I say to them that they'd understand anyway?
Just tread carefully. They could have strange customs.
Strange customs? Like what?
Yeah, like killing trespassers, Sergeant Murdoch.
We're surrounded by...
What the hell's going on back there? Oh no!
This is General Blake. All of you haul ass back to the entry point. There have been new developments.
Oh shit.
Avoid all contact with these creatures. Eliminate any if you have to. We need to bring you back now. You're in serious danger.
What the hell?
They must know something we don't know. Come on, let's go.
Mother of God, what is that?
Ah, he doesn't look very friendly.
Max and Sergeant Maxwell, talk to it.
I don't get the feeling he'd be much for conversation.
I would need for him to speak first. I don't think that's going to happen.
It's blocking the way.
Well, then I got one word for the thing.
Phil, don't!
Boom! That didn't go too well. If I didn't know better, I'd think the thing was smiling at me.
Well, hit it again!
You see that? That's just not fair. These are rockets. The kill star.
He must not give a shit.
Murdoch!
That made it angry.
Far. I have to... I've gotta be sick!
This is General McClinton. Anybody there?
Nobody here but this chicken. Now put General Blake back on. I don't want to talk to you.
Are you all out of harm's way?
There is no all, I'm afraid. It's just me. I lost Sergeant Maxwell a moment ago. There were creatures everywhere.
You located the signal from the radio in your helmet.
Yeah, well, la-di-da for you. I'm about to die out here. I got issues. Issues!
Corporal Phil, we're gonna try to bring you back, sitting a slipgate on your location and trying to pull you through the hole. Don't move.
Yeah. What about Max? You gotta make sure he's all right.
You said it yourself. There are creatures everywhere. Maybe you didn't make it. We can't risk you. The only soldier who's seen the other side.
Hey. That's bullshit, General McQuiggan. What if he survived? He's got no radio. You'll never know.
Just stay where you are.
I can't believe you're gonna sacrifice.
Thank you.
lot of gifts in the matter room.
Da bustaste from the side.
He speaks our own tongue. He must be a... Oh no.
The state of Outpost Moreau is shocking. There were many disturbing finds.
I was given a full report by Colonel Rowley, who was among the soldiers who assessed the extent of the damage.
I haven't heard the specifics.
For starters, not all bodies were accounted for. In several areas, blood smears were discovered consistent with bodies being dragged off.
Anything else?
Anything else? A base full of dead soldiers is not enough for you, I guess. Well then, if your concerns are purely mundane, then you ought to know the entire armory of Outpost Moreau was ransacked. Thousands of rounds of ammunition, nails, grenades, shells, they cleaned house.
Weapons, rocket launchers, grenade launchers.
Everything, General McQuiggan. There was one curious and particularly grisly find on top of this. I can't quite wrap my mind around a guess as to why these creatures would have done it.
Grisly in what way?
Well, there were army grunts stationed there.
I'm well aware I gave the order. They were going to participate in a security drill with the Marine station there.
Well, then they got more than they bargained for, but one army grunt was found with his head sliced wide open.
Sliced?
Yes, it's believed that these creatures were armed with heavy blades of some kind. But after annihilating the base and doing whatever else it is they did, they took the time to carve up an army grunt's skull and remove the implant.
On all the grunts?
No, only one. But being that they did this, they either had inside knowledge that the implant was there, or they have ways of sensing such things on their own. We may be dealing with very intelligent creatures.
Well, we'll find out when we take our military initiative.
But I hope to God you intend to investigate further before sending anyone else over there.
We can only gather so much from what we know, and what Lieutenant Phil reported of his experiences without sending more troops in.
Well, that's not necessarily true. A man named Jack Torres arrived here this morning. I sent for him. It is possible we can use him to see and assess the other side without endangering the lives of soldiers.
I've heard of him, but I'll be straight with you. I question the integrity of this remote viewing.
It is a documented and government-approved method, even if it does not enjoy a great deal of popularity. In the least, it is worth a shot.
That's preposterous. Next thing you know, I'll have a psychic network in here and old housewives reading tea leaves.
Jack will need a connection, even slight. Vibes, you might say. Outpost Moreau is the best candidate.
Colonel Law entry into Outpost Moreau. It was shut down as of this morning, indefinitely. It's not secure.
With all respect, sir, you can't go about this half-cock with a full military initiative. It's too premature without knowing more about them.
I'm skeptical of this Jack Torres and this psychic hocus-pocus nonsense. This is a serious threat to national security, and the attack on Outpost Moreau is an act of war, pure and simple. We need to go by the book.
How the hell do you intend to investigate this with those moron enforcers? I'm sending more men over there just to die. We lost an entire base, General McQuiggan, and four of my soldiers on top of it. My conscience and reasoning will not suffer ordering any more soldiers to march off to their death.
You have no choice but to suffer it.
Then you will do it. Without me, General McQuiggan, I will resign.
I've allowed you to undermine my decisions and military maneuvers with that threat of you resigning one too many times already. The more you make that threat, the less punch it has. If I didn't know better, I'd say you were against the Slipgate Project from the beginning.
As a matter of fact, I hope that damn Slipgate never worked, because I knew no good could come from it. Meddling with nature and science is exactly what has messed up this world to the point it is. Every blessing from science becomes a curse. It is not a matter of if, it's a matter of when.
Right, fine. But in the meanwhile, we'll be organizing a full military response. A lot of calls have been made in the past hour. Everybody is on alert. They could appear anywhere at any time. We have to be ready.
That's not totally true, though. They came through our own slip gates.
And that's where you're wrong. Outpost Moreau had no slip gates installed.
Thank you.
Well, well, if it isn't Corporal Phil. Oh, many apologies, sir. It's Lieutenant now.
Doesn't matter what it is.
Well, many apologies regardless. I just have a difficult time imagining a coward such as yourself receiving such a substantial promotion. Are you enjoying your new status, sir?
You really think I can enjoy anything at a time like this?
I think it very suspicious that 4 out of 5 men are killed and a survivor barely suffered a scratch. Perhaps you'd be inclined to tell me what it is you did to help your fellow Marines over there.
I did the best I could, Major Barnes.
I am sure trying to convince yourself of that will make you sleep better at night, Lieutenant.
I don't think I'll sleep a wink, Major Bent. And if you had half a heart, you wouldn't either.
And what do you mean by that?
I'm talking about Sergeant Maxwell, Major. You traded him like a piece of garbage. And then when you heard the news, you didn't show a bit of remorse. Some people would call you a strong man, Major Bent. I'd call you an asshole.
I will excuse your inappropriate language to a superior officer knowing you are in grief. And no, Lieutenant, I have no regrets. I did not feel pain when I was told that Sergeant Maxwell died for his country. I was proud. But of you, I cannot be proud. I can only feel shame, Lieutenant. If you were even half worthy of your rank, you would have seen to it that all 4 men returned with you.
Why don't you just leave Phil alone, Major Barron?
You've never seen a day of battle in your life, have you?
No, sir, I have not, but I am not blind. You are the sole survivor and suffered extremely minor injury. It sounds like Sergeant Maxwell and Elec Waters to me. Are you a coward, Lieutenant?
And where were you, Ben? Why weren't you there with us? You tell me who the goddamn coward is.
I was not given the opportunity.
You want to weasel your way out of it, and you know it. I know it. We all know it. Because you're that pathetically predictable. You can talk the talk, but you can't walk the walk. I'm not going to stand here and take your shit. Now, one of us is walking away from this conversation, you or me. I'll give you the choice.
As you wish, Lieutenant, we will resume our discussion when your emotions are under control. Corporal Palisoto, I understand you have put in for a discharge.
That's correct, sir.
You will keep in mind that nothing will happen until a formal hearing. Until the day that Uncle Sam says you can walk, you will perform your duties as you always have. I will not have slackers here, Corporal Palisoto. If I find your performance is less than satisfactory, or your enthusiasm is not up to par, I will have you mopping floors and cleaning toilets with your toothbrush. Do you understand, sir?
So you decided you wanted to leave the military. What brought that on?
I served my mandatory time, but regardless, how could I stay after this?
After what?
Knowing that I started it. Why, if I hadn't shot that thing, Sergeant Maxwell would still be alive. Murdoch, too. And all those boys in Tucson.
Yeah. You think blaming yourself is going to help matters?
What's done is done. I can't undo it. But I am the one to blame. Well, who knows where this all is going to lead?
If you don't mind my saying so, you do no service to their memories by quitting now.
Well, I don't know what else to do. How do you do it?
You do what?
Well, be in the military. Well, be in a place like this and deal with these things and still come across so collected. How do you hold yourself together and have a sense of humor about it? Even your mistakes.
Your mistakes make you who you are, Corporal. They can break you or it can make you stronger. You gotta look on the bright side of any situation. You'd be surprised how funny the most serious things can be. This shit happens, Corporal Palisoto. All you can do is take all the good you can sucker out of it.
What about the bad?
You bury it, Corporal. You bury it deep. That's what I do. Because life is too short.
I'm very sorry to hear the death of your soldiers, Blake.
Not half as sorry as I am. I joined the military thinking it was all drums, ribbons, and patriotism. Hero shit. In times like this, I wonder why the hell I'm here.
I agree. So I'll ask, why the hell am I here? Once again, you send someone out of the blue to hunt me down, and I end up in the last place I want to be, in another military installation.
I wouldn't have sent for you if it wasn't important.
Well, last time you were spying on the Russians. The time before that, it was locating a war criminal.
outlining foreign military bases, finding hidden silos. What now? What is it you wish to torture me with this time?
I've never understood why you come off like your talents are a curse to you. It's a gift, Jack. It's a skill like anything else.
Yes, well, this particular gift has too high a price. It is like a weapon that is ammunition. You cannot use it without cost. To me, this cost is high. Every time I employ it, it takes a piece of me with it. Nothing is free, even this. It is bending my mind and taking it to places it was never meant to go.
And how can you assume it's not meant? The people are living longer, they're taller, and the human mind is changing too. We're using more of it. That's evolution, my friend.
I don't suppose you have any idea how many months of therapy were required after that Russia thing. You know I lived the happiest not thinking about this at all. All I ever wanted to do was be a soldier, a Navy SEAL, which I was. Then boom, this comes into my life and now I am government guinea pig. I know what you will say. You will say that this is only one more time and after that, that's it. You'll never ask me to do it again. And you'll say you owe me one. The fact of the matter is you already owe me more than you could ever deliver. You take advantage of our friendship and that is not fair.
God damn it, Jack. Are you even going to ask what it's about this time?
I assumed it was the same bullshit as before, Zack. Every time the government or you has a problem, you drag me in here and expect me to wave my magic wand. Let me tell you something. I'm not going to do it this time.
How about saving the world? Is that important enough for you? Because whatever you find out very well may.
Yes, and now you are exaggerating.
Do you believe in alternate dimensions?
How could I do what I'm able to do and not believe?
You see that monstrosity over there? It's a teleportation device. Transport things from one location to another instantly.
Are you serious? I wasn't aware this kind of technology even existed. I didn't know we were advanced enough.
Advanced isn't the word I'd use, but the trick of this damn thing misfired one day and punched a hole into what Dr. Keefe described as an alternate dimension. We got the attention of the creatures living there. We know about them, they know about us. Earlier this morning, they attacked one of our bases, killing everybody. Those false soldiers I lost died in their territory. General McQuiggan and other like-minded higher powers are pushing for a war with these things, and we barely understand them. The extent of their civilization is unknown. Their plans, unknown.
And if I wasn't around, what would you do then?
I'd be forced to send more soldiers over there to possibly die. The chances are none of them would live long enough to see the things you could see from right here. You would not only be helping me, but saving some lives at the very least. But as always, it's your choice.
It's well beyond usual, however. What do I have to work with?
Well, I was hoping a slipgate would be enough, knowing they could send soldiers there.
It's not enough. Something that has been there would help.
The soldier who survived, Lieutenant Phil, will he suffice?
I just want you to know something, Zack.
What's that?
I'm not going to do it for you. I'm going to do it because it is the right thing to do.
I wouldn't want it any other way. As you asked, everyone has been cleared out. But General McQuiggan wishes to be present during this as well. I hope you have no objection.
That is fine with me. You are Lieutenant Phil.
Yeah, the one and only, yeah.
Very well, just stand off to the side and no matter what happens, don't move. I am ready now. All that I ask is silence.
Those will be as entertaining as a circus sideshow.
You promised to keep an open mind, General McQuiggan.
Any attempt at all is welcome in a situation like this. I just can't help but to feel skeptical.
they'll be far too busy fighting themselves.
We cannot afford a war with these immortals. Not at a crucial time like this.
This immortal should not even exist, General Garo. They were all slaughtered long ago in the upheaval against Nahara. Some were rumored to have escaped, however.
We have the proof right here. Humans cannot speak on tongue. It's a fact. Why would this one take the form of a human?
The form of a human was prepared because they were humans before they were ever immortal. Seasoned warriors, high priests, and pharaohs.
Yes, but why travel in company with them?
Hiding from us, of course.
Immortals can heal themselves. Why did he not do this? He allowed himself to die.
Perhaps that's what he wanted. We won't know until we talk to him.
There's one. There must be others.
Not necessarily. But I have no intention of killing this one. He is much too valuable to us.
Valuable in what way?
The runes.
Ah, yes, the runes. How soon do you think he will wake?
I cannot say. This has only been done once before, and the immortal was resurrected by my hand, and not a moment too soon. There was damage to the mind. He had little to no memory left of his life or ability. Let's hope this is not the case this time.
That's the one who lost his memory. Did he ever recover it?
Yes, but it took time, so we shall have to exercise patience. Immortals are also known to be very manipulative. But I will be able to sense if he is speaking the truth. We are in a unique position. With the other one, I had to surrender the immortal to his brethren. But the immortals are outcasts now. What few may remain. They wouldn't dare show themselves.
Then we may finally know the secret.
Yes, a riddle 4,000 years old.
You asked me to see you.
Yes, I did. About the worker.
Where are we going, may I ask?
To see Hyarch Sagaina. He has many questions for you.
Questions.
I may even get the pleasure of sending you back to the grave after he's done with you.
How comforting.
Keep a very watchful eye on the ogre. If you see any unusual behavior whatsoever, you report it to me.
Hyarch Sagaina, the immortal.
Very well. Leave us.
Do you think that wise?
Leave or I will kill you, knight. Welcome back from death, immortal. I am Sagaida.
Death, what do you mean? Why do you call me immortal?
My apologies, then. Have you a name?
I am First Sergeant Lawrence Maxwell of the United States Marines.
Lawrence? Quite an unusual name for an Egyptian.
I suppose it would be, but I'm not Egyptian.
Not Egyptian? That would be some trick, now wouldn't it?
Trick? I don't understand what you mean.
Then was I mistaken? Are you not an immortal?
I am a human being.
Interesting that you treat us so casual, human. Any other man shrinks from my presence.
I'm sorry to disappoint you. I came here with my fellow soldiers in peace to establish communication with your civilization. I still have the same intention.
You came in search of peace and wish to communicate this with weapons, then?
It was for our own protection in case we were met with hostility, which I might add we were. If it would make you feel any better, I could shrink back from you in terror, but it won't be genuine.
That's unnecessary. I was only under the impression that humans feared anything different from them or things they did not understand.
I don't see us being that different, Zagaida. Do you?
Funny, you don't talk like a human and you speak our own idiom. How is it you know our language, Lawrence? They are unspeakable from a human throat.
Call me Max, if you would.
You haven't answered my question. How did you come to know our language?
I heard one of your people speak it. When I heard enough of it, it just suddenly clicked. I also heard another speak it as I was lapsing into unconsciousness from my wounds.
It was more than unconsciousness. It was death.
Forgive me if I sound incredulous, but there is no return from death.
Then I am speaking to a corpse!
I meant no disrespect. We humans just view death as an extremely final thing.
Death is just the beginning. So, human, tell me of your past. Before you were a warrior, a soldier.
There's not much to tell, I'm afraid. I'm 28 years old, never married. I was a student, majoring in phonetics, before I was forced to fulfill an obligation to my country in joining the armed services. But I came to appreciate the military over time, even if I do not subscribe to the military way of thinking. But I value learning and I value knowledge.
You volunteer information almost too easily.
I'm being honest, Zagaida. There can be no trust between us if we are not honest with one another.
You still think you're negotiating peace, don't you?
What should I be thinking?
You should be thinking that if you were indeed human, I'd have to kill you.
Then I should definitely humor you in saying I'm not.
Amazing. You have given yourself a cover life of a human and have become so detached from what you are that you don't even know what you are. You actually believed you were human. Puzzling. Of course, your brethren, the other immortals, were only a few hundred years of age at the time of Nahara's overthrow. It was always theorized that the human mind could only retain so much. 4,000 years is a long time.
Nahara?
Yes, Max, as you call yourself. The one who made you what you are. Of course, you lost your powers the moment you died. Your death was something you could have prevented by force of will if you hadn't lost touch with those abilities over time. Have no worries, I resurrected you. But because when your kind dies, they die as mortals, as they were in the beginning. Your immortal status was God.
I see.
But it was within my power to restore it to a degree. Only Nahara himself could restore you fully, but Nahara is no more. Another story for another time. But you can thank me for restoring your immortal status in the least.
You did?
Yes, as well as your abilities. Not that you'll know how to use them, but in time, you'll remember. For now, you have potential.
Am I to gather from this generosity that you think of me as a guest rather than a prisoner?
You may. However, I do fear that your time with these humans may have concealed their truth.
What do you mean by their truth?
You may not have any recollection of the past 4 millennia, but they have proven themselves to be twisted, warlike animals. I am not afraid to tell you that your kind, be it some misguided loyalty to their roots, were known to be blindly loyal to them. Your current knowledge is limited to your memories, which decay with the years. We have watched them from the beginning, and I will show you all that we have surveyed. You can draw your own conclusions. Come forward.
Is this really necessary?
You said you value knowledge and learning. Did you lie to me? Were you deceitful to my face?
No. Very well, show me what you will then.
Click. close your eyes and clear your mind.
Corporal John Bennett, Private First Class Daniel Tate, Sergeant Michael Murdoch, is Sergeant Lawrence Maxwell. May they always be remembered for the sacrifice they made. It's a shame we cannot all be here today. In many ways, it's a shame to see all this come to an end. I can only speak for myself, but after all the time in this hole together, I have come to think of y'all as a second family. Maybe dysfunctional, but a family nonetheless. The rest of the soldiers have received their assignments except for you gentlemen. I ask for the pleasure of delivering them personally to you all as a group of equals, peers, beyond rank and any differences we have with one another. In the ways that truly matter, I view you as my friends, and I hope you feel the same way. It has been a great honor serving with you for the past 8 months. As you know, the security freeze has been lifted on this facility. It is in fact scheduled to be shut down, leaving only security here to report any future disturbances, Slipgate related. 8 months is 2 months overdue. It is high time I give you gentlemen your new orders. I wish you all the best of luck, as this may be the eve of war. Corporal Palisardo, I hear you have withdrawn your request for discharge.
Yes, I have, sir.
An admirable decision. At 1500 hours, you will take a transport to the new installation in Seattle, Washington. Well, good luck to you, Corporal.
Thank you, sir.
Major Bent, we will discuss your new orders after this meeting, as they are specialized.
Understood, General Blake.
Lieutenant Phil, you haven't quite rid yourself of me yet.
Why would I want to? You have my full respect, General Blake.
Yeah, for that I thank you. The time of transport is unannounced, but for a short time, you will be serving under me at the new Slipgate complex in Richmond, Virginia.
Yeah, I look forward to it, sir.
Colonel Riley, I hope you don't mind my grouping you up with the others.
Not at all, sir.
I hope the others here don't take offense, but after 2 years of serving with you, I think I will miss you the most. You have been my right hand, my eyes, my ears, and my friend.
Feeling is very mutual.
I expect you'll have no trouble adjusting to your new command over at Termination Central in Charleston. South Carolina is my home state. I trust she'll treat you well, Colonel Riley.
Yeah, so that's it then, huh?
That will be all. Dismissed. Major Bent.
I was very touched by your speech, General Blake. I had no idea you were so sentimental.
Well, don't let it go to your head. About the orders.
Yes, sir. I presume my next assignment will be in Georgia. Or the capital, perhaps, at General McQuiggan's right side.
Bent.
Nothing will bring me greater pleasure than being involved in the war effort.
Listen to me for a moment, Major Bent. This isn't what you're thinking.
Sir!
The fact of the matter is, you are not receiving a new assignment. That is, not immediately.
But you said this installation's being shut down.
I did. With light security left behind, you are in command of this security. A dozen soldiers at most.
There must be some mistake.
There's no mistake, Major Bent. And after 6 months here, your assignment will be returning to your duties at Thornton Military Prison.
What? I don't understand. You arranged this, didn't you? You hate me this much, General Blake.
I do not hate you, and I did not arrange this. I stuck up for you, but it did no good.
You lie. You have not approved of me since I arrived here. This was your doing. I will have you know that when my father finds out...
You want to know who to thank for this? You just said it. Your father. This was his doing, Bent.
And now you wish to turn me against my own father.
I'm telling you the truth, Ben. General McQuiggan delayed informing me of your next assignment until he could speak with Congressman Benton, your father.
That's impossible! I have proved myself! I have pushed these soldiers!
Yes, Bent, you sure as hell have. But it was all in vain. You're trying to satisfy a man who will obviously never be satisfied no matter what you do. I have no idea what's going on between you and your old man, but I would not lie to you just for sheer amusement of watching you suffer.
And where is the proof of this, sir?
You should consider yourself blessed that you ended up with the Marines you did to command. Your father arranged your transfer here, didn't he?
I did not ask him to come here. I just made it clear that I had worked off my demerits and I wanted to be transferred somewhere where I could be of more service to my country.
A few days before your arrival, a troop of Army grunts appeared here. They were assigned here by order of General McQuiggan and your father. Same breed of soldier killed each other in the Outpost Hatch incident for no reason, and just recently went AWOL off the Mexican border and started killing civilians at random. What do you think your father had in mind?
Stop!
I refused them, and I threatened resignation because I would not have them here. You have me to thank that you didn't end up commanding a bunch of brain-dead customized serial killers. It is very likely with your strong personality you would have set them off and you'd currently be dead as a doornail. Which it appears is exactly what your father had in mind.
Enough, General Blake! Enough! I believe you.
For the record, I do not hate you, Ben. If I did, I wouldn't have told you the truth. I believe you could be a great soldier. Once you make amends with your demons.
Understood, sir.
Dismissed, Major Ben.
How many times do I have to tell you it was indescribable? It was enormous with tentacles, a slimy, filthy-looking thing.
But did you see it clearly?
Yes, it comes in the form of images, words, and feelings. Whatever it was, I have a very strong feeling it was the king, the one in charge. There are many plans going on over there. Their motivations, politics. It is hard to explain.
What kind of plans?
It came to me in fragments. There is an army amassing. A real army. Something beyond what has happened to your outpost Moreau. It was like that was only a demonstration of their power. The images, the impressions were very potent, coming to me in sharp waves. Like needles jabbing. Like a quake inside my mind.
A quake? Must have been pretty intense then.
Forgive me for asking, but do you really believe him, General McQuiggan? Or is it because he's saying all the things you wanted to hear?
It's irrelevant. Whatever he had to say wouldn't have changed my course of action.
What? Then why the hell did I put myself through this?
Well, several companies of soldiers have been collected for a seek and destroy mission against the enemy. Codenamed Quake.
Cute name. Can I go now?
No. Consider yourself in military custody. We can still have use for you. Operation Counter-Strike is underway.
Am I to assume you enjoyed the good General McQuiggan's company?
Yes, comparable to giving myself a tracheotomy with an electric screwdriver.
That pleasant, then. Well, the world is about to come to an end, Jack. How about we duck out for a cup of coffee and catch up on old times?
Long as it's not the coffee in your cafeteria, you could pave roads with that shit.
Well, come on, then. I could show off my 2110 Dodge Viper, enough to make you green with envy.
Green?
Oh, no, it's black.
Something different about the ones...
Jack?
Something different about the ones in green. The green ones.
Are you all right?
Yes, I just thought I was remembering something.
Paradox Agada has assigned me as your guide, immortal. My name is Zin.
Call me Max.
As you wish, I am your humble guide and servant.
Guide in what capacity?
I will oversee your progress in remembering what you are. If you wish to remember.
The guide has sent an ogre to babysit me. Pardon me if I seem surprised.
And why are you surprised?
I got the impression that he didn't trust your entire race.
This is true. But I am a pariah amongst my people.
Oh, an outcast. How quaint. Why is that?
Because I am loyal to Sagaida and Shub-Naggarok. My crime is my loyalty to those who have inherited the land.
I see.
Come! I wish to show you something.
By the way, who is Shub-Naggarok?
She is the highest. 12 dimensions are under her rule. She gathers power to her in preparation for the end of days, when ancient elders will wake from their sleep and will come to reclaim their lands.
Reclaim? She's taken these dimensions then.
Yes. Enslaved many peoples, including my own, and saw to the destruction of your kind, the children of Nahara, the immortals. Even imprisoned Nahara.
Jagaida said Nahara was no more.
Nahara might as well be destroyed. He has magically imprisoned an ancient vault, so obscure only Shub-Naggarok knows the location. Shub-Naggarok sought expansion at that time, and had her eyes on the human realm. The immortals, your kind, left behind a riddle before they were decimated. They vowed that Nahara would have his vengeance in the end. You see this?
What is it?
Very good question. The immortals left behind 4 of them. Their claim, they are keys to Shub-Naggarok's destruction. They are indestructible and unmovable, except to mortal human hands.
And why humans?
Because the immortals knew that Shub-Naggarok had her eyes on the human realm. This was to be the human's only chance against her. This terrible prophecy frightened Shub-Naggarok enough to close herself off. In a dimension where no human can ever access. In her pit. And aborted all plans of taking over the human realm.
So she took the threat seriously.
The immortals never bluff. But even knowing that no human could ever reach her, the four runes have been under heavy guard for thousands of years.
Why does she fear if she's in a place where no human could ever go?
The fear comes in not knowing what. What they do. Only an immortal would know this.
So this explains why I get such good treatment. I'm afraid I don't have an answer. I have no recollection of any life but the human life I've lived for the past 28 years.
Let us hope you remember, before they tire of you. The truth be told, Shub-Naggarok cannot be killed. She too, like these runes, is indestructible. She is old and benign, but nothing can kill her. The fear comes in believing these runes make her death possible.
Well, as you said, no human could reach her anyway.
As long as the runes exist, and their nature is mysterious, Shub-Naggarok will worry.
Keys to her destruction. Keys.
where the hell is that shit?
Well, that would be waste product. It periodically drains into a subterranean river.
Ah, and into the oceans and water supply. Very nice.
Just telling it like it is. The typical human solution, don't you think? Just bury the waste in a big hole and everything will be all right.
You condone this?
I was being sarcastic, Jack. Get with the program. Here he comes again.
Oh, yes, I can't wait to see what the bumbling old man with a speech impediment has to say this time.
Well, with any luck, it's to tell us he's leaving.
As much as I would like to stick around, I need some caffeine.
I'll meet up with you later, Jack.
Yeah.
Ranger just arrived on the grounds, and my transport to Washington is ready. You'll give the men their commands. I trust the information I provided is in order.
Yes, sir. I was meaning to ask you. Is there any reason why you wish for me to feed Ranger a line of bullshit? He is the head of the operation. I am not thinking he should be left in the dark.
Do not speak to him in absolutes until the security level is fully cleared. He also doesn't believe in psychics and remote viewing. Better not to bring it up. Say the information came from government scientists. Give him the raw facts that I supplied.
Yes, sir. Let's hope Lieutenant Phil doesn't rush to correct me. But one more question. Did you station Army grunts here to intentionally tick me off?
I don't appreciate your tone.
In 1 month time, I will see retirement. My pension is guaranteed and secure. You can't touch me. And this is a crucial time, and these grunts are dangerous. Not just to the enemy, but to our own. I frankly don't give a good goddamn what you think, General McQuiggan. It was a bad move.
Are you questioning my authority and competency?
You're goddamn right I am. A good general's not measured by the number of stars he's racked up, or his standing in the chain of command. It's what he does with it. It's the choices that he makes.
Are you so sure your pension is secure, Zachary?
Asshole.
Yeah, they're crazy. 4 o'clock in the morning is no time to wake a man. The damn phone kept ringing and ringing and ringing. I was gonna shoot this stupid thing.
Yeah, I hate it when they pull that crap.
Stumbled out of bed and went for the phone across the room because the goddamn geniuses put the cots and the phone jacks on opposite sides. And what do you know, Phil trips on his rug and busts his lip. I was wounded. Wounded, I say.
You're a real card, man.
So I say, what do you want? I'm trying to get some sleep here. Man's gotta get some sleep. My hair's all spunked up like a punk rocker. I'm butt naked with a fat lip, and I'm picking crusties out of my eyes. What do you want? Should I say, Lieutenant Phil, pack up and head up to the Slipgate Complex, ASAP. I told them they're on hallucinogenic mushrooms, thinking I was gonna spring up and run right over here. I needed some coffee and some breakfast. The man's gotta eat breakfast. Yeah, you all look about as enthused as I am. I think we should seriously rail General Blake's ass for getting us up at such an ungodly hour.
Attention! Welcome to the Slipgate Complex, gentlemen. Your new commander needs no introduction. Ranger, your troops.
Ranger, it's really him. This guy's my hero. I never heard of him. Medals up the ass. Fought more wars and survived death 4 times than anybody. A real hero.
Thank you, General. It's great to be here. The orders.
Yeah. What kind of name is Ranger?
It's just a nickname. It's about the Slipgate device. Once we perfect these, we'll be able to use them to transport people and cargo from one place to another instantly.
Ah, I know from first-hand experience.
Silence, Lieutenant. An enemy, codenamed Quake, is using his own slipgates to insert death squads inside our bases to kill, steal, and kidnap. The hell of it is, we have no idea where he's from. Our top scientists think Quake's not from Earth, but another dimension. They say Quake's preparing to unleash his real army. whatever that is. You're our best man. This is Operation Counterstrike, and you're in charge. Find Quake and stop him. Or it. You have full authority to requisition anything you need. If the eggheads are right, all our lives are expendable.
Understood, sir.
The briefings are scheduled throughout today to provide more detailed information. I wish you the best of luck. I leave you to your men, Ranger.
Squad dismissed.
That's it, he's not gonna say anything. Yeah, man a few words, maybe.
Morning, Commander.
Morning, Commander.
Yeah, and who are you?
I'm Lieutenant Phil, I heard all about you. Yeah, you have my full respect, sir. Anything I can do for you, you just say so. I just wanted to tell
you're
you that...
You're annoying, Lieutenant Phil. Don't speak to me unless I address you first, sir.
Yeah, real nice guy, yeah.
Still feel loyalty toward the humans.
Loyalty? How could I? They disgust me. The fact that they even exist disturbs me.
The Gaidar showed you things.
He showed me the awful truth, which I already knew on some level. I always thought there was hope for them. Thousands of years and they haven't changed a bit. Generation after generation of new faces and still no progress. Funny that they consider the Neanderthals to be part of their ancient history. Not much has changed since then. They dress it up with clothes and words, concealing their evils expertly.
Old philosopher of my people once said, intelligence encourages stupidity.
Interesting statement. What is that?
Just ignore them. They are little more than ghosts to this world.
Spirits?
They are sage. You realize that nothing ever dies. It only changes into something else. Death is only the beginning.
These are your dead?
No. First race to have ever been observed was a few thousand years ago. Even today it is not common to encounter them. Unless you are in a place where there is much death.
They are drawn to it.
Yes, because they vulture on the dead. Watch the wraith.
What is it doing?
Drawing out the soul, the consciousness. All that made the creature what it was. Its knowledge especially. They gather knowledge and sift through the memories of the dead for answers.
Answers to what questions?
To where their fallen master may be hidden. Nihara.
Their master? That would make these the...
The immortals. Or what they have become. Their search is endless. Their minds gone. Only a shadow of their being remains, which understands very little.
And how do you know? Have you ever talked to a wraith?
They speak their own bizarre speech. An unknowable language. Only spoken in a realm of shades.
Really now?
Aren't you afraid he may turn against us in time?
I recognize it could happen, but after what I showed him, he certainly won't ever side with the human. Not after seeing their ugliness over the centuries. Ah, just who I wanted to see. The immortal. Has there been any progress?
Oh yes, quite a bit.
That sounds encouraging. So you have recollection of your life as an immortal?
No, but I've spent many hours listening to the signals of the human military.
Listening?
Yes, radios were built into the helmets of my comrades. I can easily eavesdrop on their conversations with it. They are scrambled, but I can decipher it.
Indeed.
It appears they've organized an offensive, planning to send troops here to your dimension with one firm goal in mind, the destruction of Shub-Niggurath.
They called her by name.
No, they have a code name for her, called Quake. I have no idea how they found out about her.
Then we strike fast.
Good. I can even tell you where to strike, where it will hurt the most.
I am beginning to like you, Max.
I have a condition.
You're in no position to make demands.
It's nothing, Hierarchsagaida. I only want to drop in on an old friend and kill him personally.
You have it. I shall gather the warriors.
Wait. First, let's divide the humans.
Divide them how?
The green ones with the machines connected to their brains. They are easily controllable because of those devices they place there. Weakened wills, no scruples, and already on the edge of turning against those who made them what they are. I shall give them a nudge the rest of the way, and enjoy the results.
Divide and conquer.
They've all been acting very strange.
I've only been here for a short time. I thought perhaps this behavior was common here. Difficult to evaluate after less than 15 hours, Lieutenant. I am appalled at the disorganized state the nation central is in. Have no worries. I will have it in order in no time.
I'm sure you will, Colonel.
Have a look at the barracks, Lieutenant. Several of your men did not show up for guard duty. I expect you will have them in order, sir.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir. Colonel Rowley, I hate to disturb you, sir, but I felt I should report some serious technical problems that have developed through the past hour.
Elaborate.
Slipgate appears to be on the fritz, and communications seem to be down. I've been trying to radio the troops on the west and east wings, but there's no response. I'm on my way now to check on the troops. They're on slipgate guard duty. See if I can't figure out why the computer keeps insisting that the slipgates are malfunctioning. The damn things aren't even supposed to be active at this hour.
Negative. Check on the other wings. I'll see to the slipgate personally.
Yes, sir.
God, what?
The slipgate has been sent to the coordinates given by the Mother's Messenger.
Have those sinful Marines been exterminated?
Almost all. There is one loose end.
Colonel Rowley, the general feeling is to bring him into service of Mother.
Oh, Jesus. Yes, he is worthy. He shall join us. We have a few teams hunting him down right now as we speak.
And once he gets his probe, our brotherhood will be united. That's my cue to leave. Colonel. After him.
You're in an awfully big hurry, Colonel. There is no escape, Colonel. But why would you want to? We are family.
And who is the mother? I am the one in command here at Termination Central.
She is the highest. We answer to a higher power now. And so too will you, Colonel. Join us. Lead us in servitude to the mother.
You have all conspired to kill your fellow Marines. What would possess you to do such a thing?
They are different from us. Impure.
Listen to me. I don't know what has happened to you all, but you are not thinking clearly. Who is this mother? A monster? From the other dimension. You cannot believe what these monsters say.
Very perceptive. How did you know? Or did you hear her calling too?
We are at war with them, not with ourselves.
Everything will make sense to you, Colonel, once we bring you down to the infirmary to have your implant supplied.
You will not stick that crap in my head, sir. It will only make me mad as you all appear to be.
You just don't understand yet. You will, Colonel. You will.
I will not.
There is no way out of here, Colonel. I don't want you to die.
I really don't.
If you resist, we will shoot you. Somewhere innocuous. Enough to wound you. And when you wake, you will wake with open eyes for the first time. In our brotherhood. And Mother will be proud.
Mother. Not only do the implants make you morons, but they make you gullible too.
Put down the weapon, Colonel. There is no reason we cannot end this peacefully. Have you ever been hit with a blaster in the kneecap? It's very unpleasant.
I am loyal to my country and my God. I will not become one of you.
You don't have a choice, Colonel Rowley. You have 20 seconds to comply before we take out your legs.
I won't. I said you don't have a choice. And that is where you are wrong. There is always a choice. You have a choice. And so do I.
This mess.
Attention. Do a full sweep of the ventilation system. Drainage areas, slipgate area. Every inch of the installation must be surveyed. Mother wants no survivors.
Oh, hurry up and die, Marine.
They are not all accounted for.
Then we find them.
Only two ways those bastards can get in here, and this is one of them. I never trusted the sons of bitches to begin with. Sooner or later, they're gonna find us.
We can't hold this position forever. We are so fucked!
Communications are down. The only thing we can do is hold strong until reinforcements get here. If they ever come. There's a hidden chamber behind me, enough to fit 5 soldiers. Survive at all costs.
It's gonna be just like you said, baby. On the beach, in the Bahamas, drinking pina coladas. I'll make it home to you, baby. I'll make it home to you.
Hear anything? Where do you think they are right now?
It is way too quiet.
around us! Hold them off!
Transport coming!
Ah! Motherfuckers! Extra! Let me in, Extra! Open up!
Hold down the last of them and secure the installation.
Come on, 15 more minutes.
Yeah, you said that a half hour ago, and a half hour before that. I got issues, Lieutenant Brown. I'm tired. I'm seeing double, and my internal organs are shutting down systematically. 19 hours of staring at the dull walls and uninspiring architecture, and I'm ready to burst. Burst, I say. I have to hear another war story from Ranger about how he took out a dozen Chinamen with a pair of sandals and a spoon. I'm gonna shave my head bald and become a Hare Krishna.
I'm gonna shoot you if you don't shut the fuck up.
15, Phil, I swear it this time.
Yeah, bunch of lazy bastards y'all are.
Piss off, Phil.
Yeah, it's all fun and games until I come in with buckets of ice water.
Afternoon, Phil. How's things going?
Hey, there's a half dozen soldiers snoozing away in the barracks. Two of them techies, one of them Lieutenant Brown, who I was supposed to relieve an hour ago. B, the rest of the techies must have broke for lunch because I can't find them. C, communications in the base went down a few minutes ago. C, A, and B. And finally, D, Ranger would rather tell old war stories and sneak in shots of whiskey than keep on top of things.
Ranger's drinking again? Well, that's unacceptable. I'll be on the lookout for him.
Yeah, if you'd like, I'll wake up the boys in the barracks. I'll just need to fetch a few buckets of ice water.
Don't you worry about them. That's not your responsibility. It's Ranger's.
Yeah, with all respect, good luck getting Ranger to do anything productive.
Well, he's gonna shape up or I'm gonna have to ship him out. Granted, there's not much he can do until we receive the supplies. Nothing but light weaponry and shells in the base right now.
Supplies is another thing that went wrong.
Never arrived?
No, it's because communications are down, we can't even check on the shipments.
I'll tell you what, there's a bi-directional slipgate on the end of the south wing. It's linked to the old base in Dallas. It's where the trucks would be unloaded. Now check on things there, see if they arrived. It's possible they did and Major Ben is slacking over there.
Oh, Major Ben, joy. Yeah, I'll scout the old neighborhood and reminisce.
You do that, Lieutenant. Ranger. Now, if I was a burned-out town drunk of a soldier, where would I be?
There I was. All I had was a stein full of beer and a key card to the back door of the installation in my hand.
12 men, you say?
Yeah, I was at the corner table at the Shockbones Tavern. I'm surrounded, my back to the wall. What's a guy to do?
Yes, what indeed?
Two of them go reaching, so I drive my knee up and flip the whole table at them. I send the stein full of beer into the eyes of the other one, and I smash it across the face of another one who tried to rush me. And I come across with the key card and I slit his throat. Then I catch a glimmer of metal in the corner of my eye. One's pulling a throwing knife. So I deflect the blade in midair with the stein and it goes right back on it. Middle of his chest. Boom.
Yeah, quite lucky for you, eh?
All steel. So I grab the table I flipped and smash a few of the fellas with it. The table leg breaks up, so now I got a broken table leg in one hand and a beer stein in the other.
Yes, very, very interesting. What happened next?
The ones left standing pulled knives and I had to fend them off. Striking with the table leg, boom, parrying with the stein. I swung around them with a roundhouse kick and caught one of them on the chin. Then I... Guys are supposed to be guarding the complex. What you all doing over here?
Hey, don't look at me like that, guys. Oh, God, Jesus, what are ya?
Get him! Help me!
Afternoon, Sergeant. Do you know if the supplies arrived yet?
Not that I know of.
I'm gonna go check on things over there.
Wigan says nobody through here without a good reason and clearance.
By order of General Blay.
Okay, you're clear then.
Any of you boys seen Ranger?
Not for a few hours. We've been awaiting his command.
If you catch sight of him, you let him know I need to have a word with him.
Yes, sir. Is there some kind of problem?
Nothing of your concern, soldier. Just man your post.
Zachary, look out! Does not look good out there. I got this gun off a fallen soldier, a nail gun. I tried to get a weapon off a Grunt's body at first, but that damn thing wouldn't work at all.
It's keyed into that signature. Enforcers are commissioned with weapons with a security feature too. Yet another bright idea of Uncle Sam. Individualized weapons that can never be used by the enemy.
Why not the weapons of the other Marines?
They are. You must have lucked out and found a weapon not commissioned to anybody in particular. Damn. I never thought my career would end this way.
Zachary, you're losing a lot of blood. The wound doesn't look so minor anymore. We need to get you out of here.
There's no way out of here as far as I know, Jack. This place was sealed up tight and with good reason. To keep out Quake's force. I guess we should have been more concerned about these grunts. I knew this day was coming, I knew it. Very badly timed, though.
Sounds like they had done about one Washington Reed.
That is what it meant.
What?
The grunts, the green uniforms. What is different about the ones in green, the grunts?
Different?
Yes, what is the difference between the grunts and us?
Other than the obvious gap in intelligence, they got brain implants, supposedly to make them better soldiers.
You once mentioned one of the grunts at Outpost Moreau being mutilated.
Yeah, they removed the... Oh, God.
They knew. They knew about the pros and took advantage of them somehow. She's there doing.
Well, a lot of good putting two and two together does us now.
Are you sure there is no way out of here?
The slip gates are still set to the base in Dallas. Getting to them is the problem.
Where is the nearest one?
Other side of this wall. There's a secret door right beside me. But I expect by the time it opens, there'll be a line of guns at the ready. Better not to give our position away. Sit tight.
You and I both know once they kill our resistance, they'll go through every inch of this place, looking for stragglers. How far is the gate from the secret door here?
Not far at all. 15 feet. They could have dismantled the goddamn thing by now, for all we know.
We have to take the chance. Waiting here to die is not an option.
I'm not gonna make it, Jack. By yourself, you have a chance. So take it. Go on.
Thank you.
Let me tell you something, Jack. If you stay here, I stay here. If you will go, then I will go too. It is not negotiable. Stubborn shit.
You always were a stubborn shit.
Slipgate to the castle of the damned, then collect the dead. Hylox the Gyno wants them all for testing. These mindless green ones were trained to guard this place. Leave half of them here to provide resistance to anyone trying to come through. Bring some to the castle. They're on our side now. I want no overzealous ogres killing them. I will make sure of it, General Goro.
Confirmation that the Slipgate complex just suffered heavy attack. General Blake has been seriously wounded. God damn it, is anybody there?
How come nobody responds?
I don't know. Communications have been down for hours. I hope General Blake will be alright, but in the meanwhile, I'll seal this place up. We don't want to suffer the same fate as the Slipgate complex.
He has lost consciousness!
Chopper just arrived. General Blake will be airlifted to the military hospital, 15 miles from here.
Lieutenant Phil just came through here earlier. Does he know?
He went to Dock A to check on supplies. He was lucky to get out of there before the shit hit the fan, if you ask me.
He still haven't fixed that thing.
No, this dock's been shut down since the incident. Supplies wouldn't arrive here anyway. They'd arrive at Dock 6. But I tell you right now, they never showed up.
What was that?
What?
Never mind. It's the radio in my helmet. Communications to base must be back up.
Sergeant Will of the Slipgate Complex, SOS, requesting immediate assistance. Security breach. The base has been taken by the enemy. I may be the only survivor. Damn it, can anybody hear me? Oh, shit!
Lieutenant Phil, what's wrong?
Both Slipgates appear to have been rigged to send to the other dimension. Judging from the imbalances.
I don't care about the slipgates. What about the soldiers stationed there?
I have no way of checking on that. Wait. North end slipgate pod just went down, deactivated. South end is no longer linked to us.
Why do you have a fireman's axe? When I run out of ammunition, I'm going back. No, sir, you cannot. Quaker's taking the slipgate complex. It's too dangerous.
I don't care, Major Ben. This slipgate leads where?
They lead nowhere. I shoot it down, Phil, as a security precaution.
Bring it back up. I want to go now.
I don't think you understand, Lieutenant Phil. Our own have turned against us. Enforcers and army grunts, they are allied with Quake now.
Blame me. They all suddenly decided to swap sides.
We don't know how, but you can't go back, Phil. Not unless you have a death wish. Once there, you may not be able to come back. Only way out is a South End slipgate. It's currently set to Quake's dimension.
God, maybe I can use it to get loose in his hometown and get to the asshole personally.
You will be facing certain death, sir.
It's not about me. It's about something much larger than me. Link me to the slipgate back to base, now! And I won't take no for an answer!
Very well, but I beg you to reconsider.
General Blake would never condone this fail.
General Blake may be dead already.
He's not. He and Jack just came through. Blake is wounded, but they're confident he'll pull through it.
Yeah, good. That's a relief.
Then there's no reason to go get yourself killed.
Who said anything about not going? Send the slipgate now. I'm not playing around here. I lost good friends in this bastard. I'm not going to sit around. I'm tired of this Quake fucking with my reality. I think it's time I start toying with his.
You can't
do it now.
Slipgate is set to the north end slipgate pad.
What? You will shut it down, sir. I am the commandant and I did not give the order.
Shut it down after I go. Major Ben, secure this facility in every way you know how. They may hit here next.
Phil, you are a fool. But good luck to you.
Likewise, Major Ben. You do your duty. I will do mine.
The slipgate is shut down. I have to cross our base to manually disable the others.
Hello, Director Keefe.
Hey, you're Sergeant... Oh, you can't be.
Goodbye, Director Keefe. I wouldn't scream again, Bent. You might startle him. And wouldn't it be a terrible tragedy to have you cut down in your prime before its time?
Maxwell, you're alive!
Oh, more so than I've ever been, Bent. You should be flattered. I came all this way just to visit you.
Jesus.
No, not Jesus. Jesus loves. I don't love you, Bent.
Please don't.
Don't what? Relinquish you of your miserable existence. Take your soul as my prize.
You made a pact with these things. You betray your country like this, you're an abomination! Made a pact with the devil!
No, Bent, I don't want your soul. Whatever would I do with it?
You will keep your distance, Satan!
Here I am, under the gun. You're so hospitable.
He has stepped into his power.
No, please!
Don't beg. Bench. It's very unbecoming.
What do you want from me? I'm sorry for the way I treated you.
A bit too late for apologies. In a moment, I'm going to kill you, Bench.
No, please, why? I never did anything that terrible to you.
You're human. Of course you deserve this. Make no mistake. You are low. You grovel for the pleasure of being called dirt. Does that sound familiar?
Why are you doing this?
Are you expecting some profound response? Because I want to, Bent. Because I would like to carry the joy of your demise with me. Not as a burden I must bear, but as a sweet memory that I can look back on and find warmth and comfort in.
No, this isn't happening.
I'm sorry, Sergeant Maxwell, I'm sorry!
Are you going to be a coward to the very end? This is your final moments. You're going to die. Nothing will change the outcome. Be a man, Major Betts. Die with some dignity, not as a crying, babbling woman.
But I don't want to die.
Well then, I've got good news and bad news for you, Major Betts. The bad news is, everyone always gets what's coming. The good news is, death is just the beginning. Good show.
Ogre claimed it was one human.
Well, whoever he works fast.
We have a few knights hunting him down. I'll go assess the situation. One human can't get far.
These humans can never be underestimated, it seems.
Daddy's got a sweet tooth tonight.
Tell me something. Why did you wait so long to kill him?
I enjoyed watching him squirm. Hello, General Gorham. I wanted to tell you that I wrapped up that personal matter.
I don't have the time to sit here. We have a problem. Seems one of the humans has decided to play hero.
Hero? In what way?
He stormed through the castle. Not a creature left standing.
I wonder who it could be.
Doesn't smell so good down here.
He's still in the necropolis, but not for long, if he isn't stopped.
You mean to tell me they couldn't stop one human? We have a shambler defending the gate.
The shambler will only stall him. This one's got a big set of balls.
Starting to get that not-so-fresh feeling.
He's not to leave. Tell the others to intercept. I'll pursue him from behind.
Sure go for a refreshing glass of peach soda right about now. I wonder if they have vending machines. A quiet living man who prefers to spend his evenings in the silence of his room, who likes an atmosphere as restful as an undiscovered tomb. A pensive man am I, a philosophic joy, who likes to meditate, contemplate, free from humanity's mad and human noise. Just a quiet living man.
If he makes it out, where will he end up?
There are hidden ways everywhere, but if he goes through the main gates, He will near Chieftain Grotto's outpost. Then, Groom Keep.
I should have ordered a chimichanga in Mexico.
You came through here like a hurricane.
I want Gloom Keep fortified. The door to Cathan is not far behind.
General Garo, everyone was destroyed.
My apologies. I had no way of knowing he was here. That's all right. I didn't like him anyway. Let's see to it, Captain.
What, may I ask, happened to the Death Knight?
Teleportation. If you teleport one thing onto another, the latter is destroyed, as you saw. Possibly the most destructive force known.
Sir Magaloff cannot be killed. She is old and benign, but nothing can kill her.
I see.
This human will not get far.
Where's this Cathan they are talking about?
Come. I will show you.
The gadgetry for those buttons.
It arises from the lava on two occasions. The first one is a ceremony performed every 600 days. He is vulnerable to electricity and very, very cranky. These electrodes are used to keep him in submission should he be in an angry mood. The fire lightning across, enough to stun him. If you will excuse me for a moment, I have some business to take care of.
Very well. I'll just have a look around if you don't mind.
Take your time. Human, if he makes it, this could be the opportunity we have been waiting for.
I don't think you understand how difficult it is to rebring how the device works. It was built to have three Archons hit the button simultaneously. I cannot bring it all to work on one button. It's just not set up that way.
You can raise the voltage to a level that is deadly to Cathan.
Yes, but that's not the problem. The problem is, even if I have the time to bring them to one button, which I don't, I will need time to put them back to normal before the Inquisitors show up.
We must do something. We cannot ignore this chance. A chance to overthrow Shub Niggurath. Max!
A human that teleports at will?
I'm learning new tricks all the time. Perks of being an immortal.
You didn't.
Over here. Oh, yes, I did. Mister, I am loyal to those who have inherited the land. That's what you like Sagaida and the others to think, don't you?
Keep your voice down, you fool.
I am chief spy for Grotto.
What are your loyalties, immortal? What do you intend to do?
Do? About your conspiracy? Nothing. I thought I might pitch in a hand.
What? You are not loyal to Sagaida?
I never was.
They're killing those men. You cannot be loyal to the humans.
Also correct. However, I've come to recognize this Shub Niggurath is just as evil as any human.
Ancient evil. Even my people fell prey to her in her nights.
Max, meet Prior, the god. He too is a spy against Shub Niggurath. He has spent years rising to a position. where he is in control of all teleportation gates and devices.
Priam, a pleasure. I overheard your dilemma. I have a simple solution.
Oh, the immortal has come with a magic cure?
No, just common sense. Can you set the electrodes to remain down for a longer delay? The human could conceivably circle the upper level and hit all the buttons.
Would a human even think of this?
I thought of it, didn't I?
Okay. Let me have a look and think. It should be easy. The human even makes it this far. If he does, the exit teleporter will lead him to another human base.
Why there?
Well, because that base is linked to another dimension. The runes are in four dimensions. I'm trying to get him to all four runes as discreetly as possible.
Set it back after he leaves to protect yourself.
But even if he makes it to Shub-Niggurath, he cannot kill her unless we think of some way.
He cannot, for that matter, even get in Shub-Niggurath's pit.
I have a suspicion that the runes open the way. Shub's move into her pit may have been a predictable one. But we won't know for sure unless we talk to the Wraiths. Which is why I need to ask about them.
Wraiths? What about them?
As in mentioned, they come from the Realm of Shades. You control the teleporters. Is there a teleport to the Realm of Shades?
Well, there is a way, but no one has ever come back from the Realm of Shades. You'd be some fool to go there.
Call me a fool, but I'll handle it.
This is true. You were one of them many years ago.
Actually, I wasn't. They assumed I was because I could speak their language. I can speak any language, Sin.
You were human!
Yes, but plenty of time to talk about this later. I want entrance to the Realm of Shades.
Priam can grant it, but do not be offended if I do not join you.
It's all right. Better I go alone anyway.
This human. You're sure he will figure it out? The buttons?
Humans may be evil, but they're very resourceful.
Okay, no way out of here. Can't go back. Nobody here but me. I'm confused. This thing looks kind of important. I wonder what it is. Yeah, that's one big mama. Lava balls, bad. Once you get your big meatball. Yeah, almost seemed too convenient. Yeah, well, here I go again. Nowhere to go but forward. Thank you.
You might ask me why I'm here before you do that.
You speak the unspeakable.
There's a first time for everything, isn't there? Children of Nahara.
They think you were one of us, but you are not. Just the master of tongs. We yearn. The Hyak made you a foul half-breed. Black sheep of the family. You come in the flesh. You are either very brave or very dumb. No one has ever returned from this place. To come here is to surrender your life.
On the contrary, you need me more among the living than you do among the dead.
You have a sense of humor. We don't need anyone.
Your curse is coming to fruition. The Beast Kathan dead. One of your runes in human hands.
Information doesn't constitute a bargaining chip for the life you sacrificed by entering here. And the rule of the law will not see the curse through.
Because Shub-Niggurath cannot be killed, correct?
Nothing extracted from the minds of countless dead have led us to believe otherwise.
That the runes are useless, unless they are truly keys to her destruction. Keys to her pit. Is that not what they are?
Entrance into her pit means nothing if she cannot be killed.
The human can defeat her with my help.
You are not a full immortal. We were. And this did not ensure our survival. What makes you so confident?
I have a proposition to make. For thousands of years you've probed for the information of where Nahara is imprisoned. I can promise it for you.
You make promises you can't possibly keep.
Shub-Niggurath is the only one who knows the location of Nahara. Harvesting her soul after her demise will reveal it. I can arrange it if the human collects all the runes and makes it far enough.
You go and serve these hypotheticals in the same breath.
And even once you know, you can't release Nahara, being not of worldly things. But I can. If I'm permitted to leave this realm.
What have you to gain? Such generosity does not come without a price.
Full immortality, as you were, with all the power that comes with it.
A case of it if you want more. Corrupted. Your parent is with the master, not with us.
Do you or do you not want your master released? Do you not want Nahara to reclaim the land Shub-Niggurath took? Not want your curse to ever come to pass. That is the pact you make with me.
And will you be as forceful with your actions as you are with your words?
Would I have risked coming here to the Realm of Shades otherwise?
Then without further ado, let's have our little talk.
What's the current count?
85 military installations were hit. 32 of them have been reclaimed. Casualties are staggering. That's not including deaths of army grunts and enforcers.
Status of the Slipgate complex?
Reclaimed, but someone cleared out the grunts before our guys even arrived.
McQuiggan!
General Blake, good to see you on your feet again.
It's just a scratch. I'd hate to be the bearer of bad news, but I was told to recommend you get in touch with Lieutenant General Burnett.
I intended on it.
ASAP. Your advocation of these implants over the years have caught up with you. For what it's worth, I hope you enjoy your early retirement, sir.
Early retirement?
Yes, sir. That will be all. You are dismissed.
Do not address me like you're my superior officer, Brigadier General.
Major General Blake, sir. And you are as good as a civilian right now. Get this scumbag out of my sight.
How dare you? For all I've done for my country, my years of dedication and servitude.
You must have mistook me for someone who gives a shit, McQuiggan. Remove yourself from the premises or I will do it for you. And I assure you, that is not something you want.
This isn't over, Zachary.
Don't let the door hit you where the good Lord splits.
Capable of anything, even coming back from the realm of shades.
It wasn't so difficult.
Why are we here? If he comes through, he may see us.
I think it'll be too occupied to go sightseeing. Besides, I want to know who this lone warrior is. To get this far, he must have killed hundreds.
Have we figured out the chase yet?
Not yet. The communicator and his helmet must be damaged.
The chase on what?
One of ours has been raising hell on the other side. We think it's the same one who cleared out all the grunts at the Slipgate complex.
On the other side? Alone?
The Ranger went through the north end Slipgate before the takeover. He's on the other side, but unlike our man, we're picking up his signal clearly, and he hasn't moved for many hours.
Ranger may be dead. This other guy, though, the way he's moving, he's got a goal in mind. He might be going after Quake himself.
You sure it's not Ranger?
100% sure.
That's... oh no. It can't be him.
Someone who was stationed at the Slipgate complex.
Someone brave.
Someone with nothing to lose.
Someone completely insane.
Oh my God, it's Phil.
It's Phil. I have now seen everything.
May God be with him. In the meanwhile, Phil could use the distraction we got cooked up for Quake's forces. Operation Counterstrike is still active. The reinforcements from 15 other countries had joined the effort.
Sir.
You heard me. Full-scale attack. The Air Force boys are already there, bombing the hell out of their villages. In 1,200 hours, we're sweeping the bastards to Kingdom Come. You're coming with me, Lieutenant Riggs.
I'm not Riggs, sir. I'm Lieutenant Jacobs.
Right. My apologies, Lieutenant.
Jack,
I have a confession to make. Sometimes I have a hard time telling these guys apart.
Don't worry, Zachary. They all look the same to me, too.
It is a damn shame about all the men we lost. I suppose in a strange sort of way, it's better for Keith not to live to see this.
Keith had good intentions with the Slipgate. Look at all the problems it brought.
Yes, his family in San Francisco was notified, and they're handling it very well.
San Francisco? I thought he was Scottish.
Oregon and Montana ain't the
position at Rendezvous Checkpoint Charlie. Roger that. Recon status.
Recon unit then route to the original triangle for retrieval.
Damn things are still parading in our wake.
Coming to. Commission the sweep.
Confirm ammo where possible.
Unit 12, samples indicate another squad of tin pans on the way.
Unit 14, took a good boat from a snowman, experiencing system failure.
Unit 12, it's a dirty job, but someone's gotta do it. I'm on them.
Sometimes I love this job. Roger that. They just keep coming.
But then I drop one of these things, five more of them spring up to replace it.
Oregon locked down. Montana locked down. Stand by for recon for original rendezvous and my signal.
We must move the army from the fortress. We wait for General Goyle's commands.
Unit leader, what happened to Unit 14?
Unit 14, navigation system cluster fuck.
Unit leader, Unit 14, authorized remote guidance system.
Unit 14, tracking transmitter malfunctioning, descending to minimize engine strain. I can see the outline of a structure through the viewing window to my flank.
Stand by, Recon 14, while we locate you.
Unit 14, make it quick, engine's dying.
Destroyed. Recon's in place. Stand by for mark and retrieval. Time to ruin the afternoon.
Find out about their rules.
I was right. They opened the way to Shub-Niggurath's pit. Only other thing they do is offer information.
What kind of information?
Yes, it fuels a desire to collect all four runes. Of course, the information it gives is 4,000 years out of date. But no matter.
Leveled the fortress of Zergon and lands for miles and miles around to the ground with one powerful swipe. The dimension of the Doomed is barely even inhabitable.
Nuclear weapons. They've made their statement. They'll now wait to see what we'll do. Use this time to track down this threat to Shub-Niggurath.
I think not, Hoyar. There is no threat, with or without the runes. I'm withdrawing my armies into the highlands.
What? You will not? I forbid it!
I'm not prepared to contend with these nuclear weapons, as you call them. Stay here and die for all I care. Only out to bide our time.
You dare to turn your back on me? I'm the master! You will be hunted till the end of your days. You will suffer 1,000 curses, 1,000 torments, and your carcass will be dragged through the ancient halls of Azathoth and fed to the fiends!
You know, I've grown very tired of being your bitch. Knights! Kill him!
You can't do this!
I just did.
There's just one like it in Shub-Niggurath's pit. I invented it myself, though it didn't turn out very efficient, which is why I was supposed to remove it. However, I believe it will suit our purposes nicely.
How does it work?
You link it to a teleporter, it travels across, and when you step through the teleporter, it will take you to its location.
Wouldn't you destroy it when you came through at its location?
No, this isn't solid, it only appears to be. The illusion is a visual aid, so you know where it is.
Why not just link the teleporter to Shub-Niggurath's location?
It isn't the time, it would be deemed suspicious. I can change the course of the teleport train while her guardians are occupied in trying to stop the human. It will pass straight through her, but like we had in Cathan's lair, it's going to take him figuring out the puzzle.
The buttons I credit him for. This, I don't know.
Unless you have any other bright ideas, this is all we have to work with.
I know this humor. I could wait in Shub's pit and tell him how to kill her.
The Realm of Shades wasn't easy. Shub-Niggurath's pit, impossible. The magical barrier around her pit restricts access to only a select few, me being one of them. With the exception of this human, who will have the 4 runes as his means.
One more question. Can the Wraiths penetrate this magical barrier?
Wraiths can enter anywhere. Why do you ask this?
Because Shub-Niggurath's soul is on the dinner menu, I'm sure.
And what a delightful meal it should prove to be. Very well, next time you see me, it will be after the death of Shub-Niggurath, I hope.
What bargain did you make with these Wraiths? They, too, are evil, Max. This business with the Wraiths concerns me.
It should, Zin. The beast Nahara will soon be freed from his ancient bondage.
What? You offer to release Nahara? But why? You don't even know what effect this millennia have had on him. You cannot control him, Max. He is a god.
God. Immortal. These are loose terms around here, Zin. He's a gigantic beast, able to grant enormous power, but ironically has so little of his own. I know. The Wraith Aemon Bezek and I had a long talk.
You are selfish! And you are not satisfied with what Sagaina gave you. Look at what you are becoming! Nahara was said to be the most powerful of all the ancient elders, even above the Zerstörer.
Because he surrounded himself with disciples that he empowered with potent magics. Come to think of it, that's what Shub-Niggurath herself does.
What is it you will do with all this power you lust for, Max?
But Shub-Niggurath is gone. Someone must replace her. Why should I limit myself? I lived on Earth for nobody. Here, I can be number one.
Listen to what you are saying. This is not you.
You don't know me, Zin. I like you. Which is why I will gain no pleasure from killing you.
Do you expect me to run now, Max?
You and I both know I'd catch you in a blink.
You would murder me! What have I done to you? What have I done to this Alice and someone whom I thought was a friend?
I'll need the full trust of the knights and monsters. They cannot know that I am allied with the Wraiths.
they cannot for that matter know that I helped orchestrate the death of Shub-Negoro. Plainly put, you know too much. And beyond all this, I cannot suffer a spy in my ranks. Don't fret. Your life was not without perks.
Here, ready to kick some butt. I wonder what this thing is. Yeah, I feel so low. This is me. This is one man. Against Shub-Negoro, the Hellmother, the Witch Goddess. I think I have a serious wedgie from all this fighting. Coming to get you, sugar, sugar, baby! So this is Shub-Negoro, huh? Doesn't even move. He's not very scary. This must be some kind of joke. He's kind of big. What if I should shoot her? Must be another way. Can't get across the lava. Yeah, yeah, I'm hot. I'm hot tonight. Somebody stop me. I don't like these spiders. I wonder where this goes.
Guider liked it lavish, didn't you? The exterior is very reminiscent of mansions on Earth.
He was very particular. A shame it's going to sit and rot here now that he's gone.
On the contrary, I think I fancy it enough to stay.
That may not be the wisest choice. If the other Archgolds find you here, they're liable to throw a very big, ishy fit over it.
I guess that's my problem if it happens.
Suit yourself. At any rate, it's been a pleasure working with you. My people are very grateful. It's a tragedy what happened to Zin.
Yes, I wish I knew how the Hell Knights found out about it.
I suppose I'll be joining him if I'm not too careful. The Four discovered my change in the teleport chain route, but I enjoy the protection of my people.
That's right. You have a bit of a price on your head now. Tread carefully, Friar.
I will, and if anything happens to me, at least I'll die knowing that my people are free.
Indeed. I'm sorry, Trial. I just can't trust it.
How did you... Oh, very well. So you found me. Now get on with it. The whole staring thing is so passe.
General Garo, so glad you could make it.
So, Max the Immortal still lives.
A pity about Hayak Zagaida, isn't it? I must wonder how long the Arch-Council will buy the story that the humans are responsible. It must have felt good to have him slain.
You take great risk by bringing me here to tell me this, especially with no protection. How could you know?
Oh, a little birdie told me. The dead do speak, General Garo.
What is it you want? These are dangerous times, times of chaos.
Come to the territory of an empty throne, General.
No need to address me by rank unless you're one of mine. The Empire is falling apart. All creatures are destined to part ways.
It doesn't have to be that way. With Shub-Niggurath gone, someone else could rise to power.
You're naive. Shub-Niggurath had influence over the mass consciousness. If you think me, then you're terribly mistaken. I haven't the power level to become the master, nor would I want that burden, that responsibility.
I'm aware of this, but how would you feel about being the master's first, right hand, general of the armies and lawgiver wrapped in one?
Well, well, well. Max the Immortal becomes Max the Ambitious. I know Zagaida granted you power, but it won't be enough. Don't think your power won't be questioned. Don't think you won't be challenged. You won't last a day, Max.
At the moment, no. Tomorrow, yes. You see, I have an appointment to keep with an ancient acquaintance of Shub-Niggurath, sealed for years by her magic, the same magic which makes him subservient to the one who releases him, and very generous with gifts. Nahara.
That's the most absurd thing I've ever heard. The Lawgiver! Right hand to Elder Level power! Where do I sign up?
I knew you'd come around, General.
I gather you here today to make an announcement. You, Once as the Inquisitors and loyal council members for Shub-Niggurath should be the first to know. I know you mourn for the loss of Shub-Niggurath, in fear that the death of our ways is on the horizon. Let me put your minds at ease by informing you that we will continue on as we were. Your status in the kingdom, intact. I say this as active general, high up, and lawgiver to him. Tomorrow enters the new master. Tempt his wrath, he will deliver suffering with unfathomable power and might. All those who do not pledge their loyalty will be decimated. And for the rest of us, it's business as usual.
I'm going to make you an offer you couldn't possibly refuse.
Thank you.